Good afternoon and welcome to Hudson Fields here at Hazen Union High School in Hardwick, Vermont. Baseball playoff action today. First game Hazen has hosted since 2007. Your number 5 seeded Wildcats come in with a record of 10-6. They're taking on the number 12 Oxbow Olympians. Coming with a record of 3-12. The winner of this game plays the winner between Bellows Falls and Northfield. Northfield a 4 seed at a 10-6 record. Northfield a 13 seed with 2-7. They'll play Friday, June 4th. Hazen did not play Oxbow in the regular season, so these two teams might not know each other all that well. Lance Hall with the call for HCTV, channel 1080 on your cable dial, streaming worldwide and archived at www.hctv.us. Hazen comes in on a two-game losing streak to end the season. They lost a 10-inning marathon here at Hudson Fields against the People's Academy Wolves, 8-4. Last Tuesday, then they lost at Spalding last Thursday, 17-7. Oxbow lost their final 8 games of the season, but 6 of those were against D2 teams. So, you know what? It's the playoffs. We throw the records out and we start anew. And jogging up the hill is the one and only James Salvis joining me to do his stellar job on play-by-play as I go one-on-one with the great one. James Salvis, how you doing today, James?
I'm doing very good, Lance. How are you?
Not too bad. I'll hang on to the pen. Do you want the pen?
You can hang on to it.
All right. Our sponsors today, Buffalo Mountain Power Sports, 472-5522. Buffalo Mountain supports Hazen. And Sperry Lawn Care, 745-8336, when others can't cut it. Sperry's can. And what a glorious day for baseball it is, James Salvis.
Yes, finally good to not have some of that cold May weather.
Yeah.
That we got the last, you know. Cool. Memorial Day weekend and stuff like that.
Over the weekend, it was a bit chilly, rainy, crappy. It's not a good Memorial Day.
It really was not. It was a little bit cold.
Skies have cleared, and the vortex, I have a good authority that the vortex is going to behave itself today, and we should have some fantastic baseball out here.
That is always a good sign, Lance.
Yes, indeed.
When the Hall Mountain vortex behaves, should be a good day. You want me to clip that on here, Lance?
You know what? I'll hang on to it now. I'll just do the read as we go along.
All right, sounds good to me.
And as long as we're still killing a little bit of time, if you can just pull this down for just one moment. I did take a few notes here for you, James. I'm sure you know this, but your People's Academy Wolves play number 15 Mill River tomorrow. The winner of that game goes on to play the winner of, Woodstock Green Mountain. And they'll play on Saturday. So I just wanted to give you a few props. For your alma mater.
Yes, game tomorrow.
Yes. So you didn't have to worry about choosing where you were going to be today, which was very fortuitous for us at HCTV.
Yes, very, very good for us here.
Leaf on camera today.
Yes, Leaf Goldberg,
yes.
The one and only.
So, opening pitch moments away.
Yes, for these Oxbow Olympians, who actually, I commentated a basketball game up at Linden Institute, and they played these Oxbow Olympians, so some of these names are kind of familiar.
Yeah, I recognize some of the names as I was doing the starting lineups. Or not the starting lineups, but the lineups for the players, I should say.
Yep.
Oxbow, nice ride up from I-91. Takes a little over an hour probably on a bus to get here. So
yep.
I'm sure they've got their legs under them by now. They're younger than I am anyway, so they can bounce back all that much quicker on those long rides.
Yep. You know, Oxbow up in Bradford, VT.
Yep. First game, first playoff game Hazen has hosted since 2007. They won that game that day, and I believe, we don't have it absolutely confirmed, but we're thinking it could have been Tristan Southworth on the mound that day for the Wildcats. Of course, Tristan honored this past Sunday, Coca-Cola 600, driver of the number 17 car. I can't remember
Chris Buescher.
Okay. Had his name on the windshield. Nice honor to have.
It was very, very, very great to see that. You know, my dad, a big NASCAR fan, so, you know, we were tuning into the race, and that was a very, you know, good thing to see, especially for the Hardwick community and just Vermont in general. As you see down there next to the dugout, you see his, you know, name up there as always, as his number 13 hangs in the gym.
He's with us.
He always is. I'm sure he's very proud of this Wildcat team today.
Yeah, this has been a fun team to watch. We've seen him play a lot this year. This is our first year of covering baseball for HCTV. It's been a ball.
And, sure has.
You know, we've seen them be very aggressive at the plate, very aggressive, especially very aggressive on the base running.
Oh, absolutely.
And who do we have starting for our pitcher today?
We have Lyle Rooney.
Lyle Rooney. As good a pitcher as we'll find out here today on the mound.
Lyle the Rocket Rooney.
There we go.
I was trying to think of a different, better pitching nickname. I'll Try and think of something better than the
Rocket.
Well,
the Rocket is good. You know, right in there with Clemens, right?
Yeah, Roger the Rocket. As Reese Hillsley stands in now for the Oxbow Olympians. As yes, although I kind of have nightmares when PA plays Mill River in the playoffs, Lance.
Hazen boys, I believe, lost to Mill River last year in the soccer playoffs. Went down there for that game.
High ball from Rooney. 1-0 now to Ilsley. But I believe you're right, Lance. As PA, the defending Division III state champions, boys soccer.
Fell back right underneath the car. Not minimal damage to the rocker panel.
We have no Randy Lambston back there to make a nice catch.
Randy's not back. No, I don't think he could have caught that one.
Nope, that one was coming
hot.
That was
a scorcher.
1-1 now to Ilsley. Rooney kicks and fires. Another one fouled back to us, headed for the parking lot. That's going to scoot over there by the main entrance here of Hazen Union.
Just made it up to the main entrance.
Sure did. 1-2 now to Ilsley. Not used to seeing Rooney on the mound, at least I'm not. So
I've seen him once. I guess they've sort of been saving him, I guess, for the playoffs.
Playoffs.
I haven't gotten to say that in a long time. Of course, paying homage to the great Jim Mora.
And Allen Iverson as well. Talked about.
Iverson was more of a proud. There's a solid hit.
Yeah. Base knock into left field by Reese Ilsley. That one seemed pretty hard off the bat. Yeah.
I thought Iverson was practice.
Practice.
We're talking practice. Yeah. Mora was playoffs.
Yeah.
When he asked if his team was going to be ready for the playoffs. Playoffs?
Yeah.
Playoffs. I don't think we're going to be ready to win a game. One of the great quotes of all time from Jim Mora when he was coaching the Colts.
Yeah. And like I said, the one from Iverson, you're right. That's practice.
Practice. We're talking practice.
Runner on now. Rooney's going to pitch from the stretch. He kicks and fires. Swing and a miss by Andrew Emerson, basketball player for the Oxbow Olympians. Pretty solid basketball player for the Olympians, mm-hmm. from what I recall.
Yeah.
Cousin of Ben Emerson, who was a heck of an athlete, one of the greatest in Oxbow history, actually. It looks like that one got through the fence.
Yeah. Hmm.
Hit that one so hard, put a hole in the Hudson backstop.
Yeah, a little bit of a gap right there at the top. You see they've kind of zip-tied it.
Oh, yes. That must have been where it squeaked through.
Note to self, never sit directly behind the backstop.
Yes, 0-2 now. Ilsley offers.
Quick throw down to first, doesn't get him.
Oh, you see Montgomery there, quick on the draw to throw down to first base.
And I did hear some chatter down there as I was by the field. I thought I heard them say that James is going to be batting today.
He is. He is hitting today.
Okay.
No DH today for the Wildcats. As Carter Allen stands in for the Oxbow Olympians. A little bit different, Lance. I'm on left side today.
Yeah, how you liking it?
It's nice.
A little bit better view over there.
That's in there for a strike. See, I think that first hit, we shouldn't have anything to worry about today for Rooney. You know, I think he was just warming up a little bit.
Kid made solid contact.
He did. I think he just left it a little too much over the plate.
Base runner goes.
He's going.
Montgomery throwing. Not there in time.
Pulls Revard a little bit too far to the right. I think if that had been a straight throw, we might have got him.
Kid had a great jump, though.
He sure did. You could tell he was running all the way.
Yep.
1-1 now to Allen from Rooney. Rooney is going to kick and fire. That's in there, strike two. Lyle the Rocket Rooney. Rooney is going to kick and deliver. That ball is hit sky high. Davison calls it. He takes it. Infield fly right there.
Tyson Davison.
Well, I don't think they called that an infield fly rule, but it was an infield pop-up.
Now, explain to me the infield fly rule. I've heard that term, but I have absolutely no clue what it means.
If you see the pitcher go like this and kind of point straight up in the air, it means he's calling for the infield fly. So that means if the catcher drop, or if the fielder drops it, then I believe the runner is still out, or something like that. Lance, that is one of the rules in baseball. I actually don't know entirely how it works.
We'll have to research it.
The infield fly. Now Hazen in the next round, as the first pitch was a foul ball to Chase Lund, fouled it off for a strike. as you see for the Wildcats, there would have to be an upset at the other side of the bracket for them to have another home playoff game. That ball's hit hard on the ground. Rivard's going to scoop it up, take a couple steps, fires to Gould, and he got him. So after one hit, Rooney settles in.
Solid pitching from Lyle Rooney. Great fielding behind him out there.
You see Rivard?
Yep.
Not trying to throw it too hard today. Just
exactly.
Right.
We've
to
seen
the
him
mitt.
Do that before. He kind of settled in and got it down and then
he
made
sure
the throw.
Did.
Yeah. I mean, Bellows Fall at 10-6. We've seen Northfield play. At least I've seen Northfield play up here. Their record at 2-2 and something.
I thought they were 2-7.
2-7. They're a 13 seed. So
2-7-0.
Hey,
you know, I was
anything can happen. I mean,
you know, sure can.
The Hazen girls soccer team wrote a couple of upsets by
they sure
teams
did.
Last year to get into the finals.
On top of playing well themselves.
Yeah, exactly.
Beating some good teams on top
they
of that to
get there.
Beat
some good teams, and then there were a couple of upsets on the other side of the bracket that, you know, hey, before you know it.
Yeah.
So anything can happen. Like you say, you throw the records out come playoff time.
Oh, that's the same in any sport, but I think in baseball it's the craziest in my opinion.
Absolutely.
Because baseball, just literally any team can have a good day in baseball in the playoffs, and you're done.
You get a hot pitcher or a hot hitter or something, and, mm-hmm. you know.
And if you don't mind me bringing up the People's Wolves again, my freshman year here, we were a 5 seed just like the Hazen Wildcats and managed to get all the way to the semis before falling to Enosburg, who was the number 1 seed. And we gave them a heck of a game down in Enosburg. They were just solid pitching, solid batting all around. They were a really tough team. But, you know, so were we after we started the year, I believe, 0-3.
Right.
Including one of those losses to the Hazen Wildcats. And we wound up scraping a 5th seed, and we just had the will to win.
Anything can happen.
And it's all about getting hot, too, I think, Lance.
At the right time.
Finding a hot streak. And the same thing happened for, you know, the Wolves during basketball season my senior year. Got hot with, you know, a late season win against the Wildcats, and then took that and, you know, just kind of rode that momentum through playoffs and got back to the yacht.
And I'll go back to the Hazen girls soccer team of last fall. You know, they rode a lot of momentum into the playoffs and, you know, got some scoring and some defense, some good goalkeeping. And
they sure did. Allie Gabbery, heck of a goalkeeper for.
Got it all in there.
Allie Gabbery, heck of a goalkeeper, too, for the
awesome.
Hazen Wildcats.
Yes.
On top of some very, you know, good players on that team as well.
Yeah.
You know, your daughter, Lance, very good. Macy Moeller on that team as well. She's good.
Yeah.
Really trying to think of anybody else.
Yeah, actually, Joey didn't play last year. She had graduated. But,
oh.
But she was on there the year before.
Yes.
But, yeah, you had
Macy Moeller.
Macy was
Maddie
very
Bartlett
good.
Played,
Maddie
I
Bartlett
believe.
Played
Riley Brochu. As Little Shopper, we'll go back to that today. Little Shopper stands in for the Wildcats.
Yes, last game he graduated up to the Shopper.
He sure
for
did.
His final senior game and had a whale of a game.
He really did.
Made some incredible catches out there in center field.
Had a great interview before the game.
And here go the Parrots.
Yep. As you see, one thing now I notice for Little Shopper, Lance, is if you look at his feet placement in the batter's box, it's very unorthodox. Where he stands, a lot of guys are going to stand towards the middle, but he kind of crowds that.
He's kind of creeping in on the plate, yeah.
Kind of crowds the plate, gets that right-hand corner. I think that's for, there's a strike, but I think the strategy a lot in that, Lance, is if a ball is inside, that could sometimes be called a strike. It'll be called a ball because it'll be a little bit further inside if you're crowding the plate. And you can also cover more of the plate.
Be interesting to see if the pitcher tries to brush him back a little bit. There's some solid contact out to
that's
right.
That's going
to
find the gap.
I think Shopper's going to go for 2 and get 2.
He is. Shopper will be into 2 standing.
All right.
Base hit.
Solid leadoff for the Little Shopper.
Sure is.
Nice double.
Doubles machine.
And in steps T-Rex.
Tyler
Rivard.
Yes, Tyler Rivard. As you did
awesome.
A great job on the starting lineups today, as always, Lance.
Took me a minute to build up a little momentum. I've kind of been out of shape a little bit. I only did 2 basketball games this past year, only went senior nights. And so, yeah, it took me a minute to build it up there a little bit. Rivard
pop
gets
up.
Underneath that one.
Shortstop calls for it. He puts it away. Oh, yeah, I got to see. As Chase Lund is on the mound for the Oxbow Olympians today. But you're right, you can just throw the records right out the window during the playoffs. Records do not matter. As you said, they play a tough schedule too, D2.
Yeah, they played a lot. You know, like I said, they lost their last 8, but 6 of those were against D2 teams. So they definitely, if anything, toughened them up coming into the playoffs.
Jaden Baker stands in now.
The butcher, the baker, the home run maker. Turn around, quick throw. Oh, he got him.
And
Todd Schopper out there kind of
taking a nap over there.
A little bit on second. You don't see that happen too often.
You definitely don't.
He's usually right on his game.
And just like that, there's two outs for the Hazen Wildcats, and there goes.
Great throw by the pitcher to turn around and snap that ball back to second.
It sure was. Lund with quick reaction there to get it back to second base.
Nice tag by the second baseman as well.
Sure was.
Baker.
Pitcher wants time, step off. Northfield Marauders, even though they have not a great record, they're always a tough team. Swing and a miss. Jaden Baker, as I like to say, was swinging for the Judavine.
Mm-hmm.
Swinging for Right Way Sports. 0-1 now for Baker. Lund kicks and fires. As you see Lund with kind of a three-quarter sidearm release a little bit.
We've seen a couple different pitchers go with that this year.
We have. You know, one of the players up at Linden at the college, one of my friends kind of throws sidearm. Really throws you off as a batter, Lance, because mm-hmm. you really don't know what way the pitch is going to move.
Tough
this pitch, oh, Baker called a foul, must have hit right in front of home plate.
This will give the Seagulls something to chirp about.
Sure will, 1-2.
I mean, we can't really hear the opposing team's bench because they're behind the dugout, but I'll tell you, I got to give the Hazen bench, you know, they are the greatest talkers.
They sure are. You know, that's just classic baseball talk, too, Lance. This happens all the time. It's very common in baseball. Pitch from Lund. That is low for ball two. 2-2 now to the butcher, the baker, the home run maker, Jaden Baker. Said that to Mike Baker just before the game, Lance, and he was a big fan.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Mike DeMann Baker.
Pitch from Lund. That's low, full count. You know, Lance, when I get to commentate a basketball game here again, I'm going to have to start using that. Mike DeMann Baker.
Mike,
do you have one
DeMann
for Aaron
Baker.
Hill? Aaron's been here forever.
Usually just call him coach, but I'll tell you, I'll come up with something.
Pitch from Lund. That's low, and the Baker's going to draw a walk. As Lyle the Rocket Rooney stands in now. I hope he appreciates that. I just say that because it's a common pitcher term for when you're throwing gas.
I have no doubt that Lyle will love that nickname.
When you throw heat. Like you said, a la Roger Clemens. Roger, great pitcher for the Red Sox, Yankees, and Astros. I don't like to think of his time in New York, though. Another quick throw by the pitcher back to first. That's at the time where he was juicing, doing illegal stuff.
Hell, everybody was at that time, though.
That was the steroid era.
Yep.
Pitch now from Lund.
Baker takes off, throw down.
Ball it gets by. Baker thought about going to third. He's going to stay.
Wise decision.
Very wise.
So let's see what Lyle can do with his bat.
It's 1-0 now to Lyle Rooney. First pitch, he was going. So Baker is going to get the swiped bag. As you see, aggressive base running by the Wildcats. As Shopland had a double.
Right.
And then Baker with a stolen base.
Same aggressive style we've seen all season. Spencer likes to keep him running.
He sure does. That is fouled back, headed towards, well, almost got up to the parking lot. It's going to be on the hill over there by the Hudson Field.
I didn't get to look down. When I was on the bench, I was kind of concentrating on my names and everything. Is the trooper here today?
He sure is. He's down there right against the dugout.
The trooper. Opie upset.
2-1 now to Rooney. See, Rooney with the high stirrup socks. Love it.
Old-time baseball.
Yes, ooh, that one almost
clipped
hits him in the ankle. Rooney might try and throw one back at him in the bottom half. You see, that's one thing, you know, with a pitcher, Lance, when you, I don't think that was intentional, but when there is intent, you got to try and get him back in the bottom half. Lund is going to kick and deliver. That's going to be low for ball four. Rooney draws a walk, so back-to-back walks by Chase Lund. As that brings in James Montgomery.
Swinging the bat for the first time. Well, I don't know. Did he swing against Spalding?
I have no idea.
I don't know if he did or not. First time we've seen him swing here in a little bit.
Yes.
Of course, he was out for a few games with the sprained AC. And he's been behind the plate, but we've seen pinch hitters for him.
And I'm sure he hits the ball very well.
Absolutely. Runners go. Throw down to third. They're in. Ball goes by. I think we're going to have a run score.
Yes, Jaden Baker's going to come in. Rooney goes to third, where he's going to be held up. And it's 1-0, Hayes and Wildcats. Wise decision there by Spencer Howard to hold up Rooney at third base. He would have been hosed at the plate if he went.
He would have. Hazen on top, one zip.
On the throwing error down to third base.
But that same aggressive style of running.
That has. Well,
that will be, that's sort of their mantra.
That has produced so many runs for the Wildcats.
Talked about that a lot. So
see Adam Gann in attendance.
Adam Gann. Yes, he is, right over there.
Another assistant coach for the men's basketball. Low for ball.
Okay, so we've got Rooney at third, Montgomery batting. 1-1 is the count?
Yes, 1-1 to James Montgomery.
James. Two outs, bottom of the first, Hazen up one zip.
James, what a fantastic name. Yes, I'm biased. Pitch now. Ooh, Montgomery swings through it for a ball, or strike, I mean. Jeez. If you ever see a swing and miss ball, then that'll,
yeah,
that'll be just changing the whole rules of baseball. Montgomery hitting in the five spot today, so hitting pretty high in the lineup. The Mahler Menard on deck.
Andrew the Mahler Menard. Montgomery fouls back.
Seemed like he wanted that pitch too, a little bit high to me, but looked like he wanted it. Mm-hmm. As it's 1-2 now from Lund to Montgomery. Lund kicks and delivers. Montgomery fouls that one back over the backstop.
Of course, Robbie's some great baseball lineage. His dad, James, great baseball lineage. His father, Rob Montgomery, I believe went Twin State.
Yes.
When he played for Hazen here, played in a Twin State game.
Yes, Robbie was a good baseball player as well. So good at, good athletic genes for James. That ball is hit hard on the ground. Montgomery's digging to first base, and he's going to beat it.
And Rooney comes in to put the Cats up 2-0.
Rooney scores. RBI for Montgomery, kind of a swinging bunt, as you could say, just a little tapper down the third base line, but third baseman was playing deep.
Montgomery showing great speed to get up there and make the play, and it gets himself on base. Little two-out rally, right?
Yes, for Andrew the Mahler, Menard. Hot one today, Lance. Good to see.
When the sun's out, it is a little warm. I don't know if I'm going to regret wearing this black shirt or not.
I got a nice light shirt on today.
I usually go with white if I'm going to be in the sun. But when I left the house, it was sort of, there were a lot of clouds. But that's up in Greensboro Bend. That's another part of the world from here.
That's, vortex. That's like a completely different.
Yeah, that's on the other side of the vortex.
Yeah.
There goes James down through. Throw down. Montgomery in.
Safe. They applied the 10.
Safe at second base.
Bang, bang play over there, too. That was a close play. But he was safe.
Cats not letting up.
They are not.
And we've seen the Mahler hit the ball a ton.
We have. As you see, Spencer just keeps him running. Pitch now by Lund. I don't know why I said Gould. Probably because Aisha's on deck.
There we go.
Pitch now from Lund is high. I'll get it right this time.
3-0 your count?
Yes. No. 2-1.
2-1?
2-1. That's what it says.
Yeah. I thought I saw three dots up there. Then I heard the umpire say 2-1. So.
Yes. As they thought it was 3-0 as well. Pitch now from Lund. That is rocketed to left field.
Foul.
I'm going to hook foul. The wind taking that one a little bit for Andrew the Mahler Menard.
Or as we would say in hockey, shot wide on the net.
Sure was. Speaking of which, the Boston Bruins took a tough loss to the New York Islanders in overtime last night.
And I'll take that any day of the week.
After being down 3-1, tying it at 3 to send it to overtime. And then falling to those dang Islanders to tie the series at 1 apiece. Oh, 2-2 now. Here's the pitch. That's going to be outside. Good eye by Andrew the Mahler Menard. Gould takes a look at second. Pitch now to Menard. He's going to foul one back. That one, I didn't really see that one for a second. Kind of lost it in the sun.
Yeah, lost in the sun. Didn't quite make the flagpole, though.
Did not. Only a little shopper has that kind of power to hit the flagpole.
And he hit it up high
he
on
did.
The flagpole.
I mean, there's probably a dent in that flagpole, honestly. That thing's been here since.
Foul off the backstop.
God knows. That thing's probably been here since 78. Probably longer than that. That's
maybe 1970 when the school opened. Or,
yeah, you know, probably, honestly. I believe that's when it became Hazen Union instead of Hardwick Academy.
Yes. Everything got unified.
Sure did. PA has always been an academy as far as I know. Full count now for Menard. He kicks. Gould kicks it, fires just outside.
Lund wanted the call. You see him a little bit.
Yeah.
I don't know if he's upset with the call or with himself or.
Just a bit outside. Lund tried the corner and missed. A la Bob Uecker.
Yes, sir.
Aisha Gould now to stand in. Two on and two out for the Hazen Wildcats. Lund in trouble. Pitch from it.
Running. And we had.
Had to show him the ball at third base. That's what that was.
Okay.
And now he's out.
So now he's out.
He just had to make, the ump had to make sure that he had the ball.
So the Cats wanted to try and keep up that aggressive base running. But and he was close.
He was close. He was close. That was a very close play, but.
So at the end of one, it is your Hazen Union Wildcats leading these Oxbow Olympians by a score of 2-0.
Yes.
Once again, this is baseball playdown action. First game, playoff game at Hazen since 2007.
The year I believe they went on to the state championship.
Lost to Northfield in the finals that year. So once again, you're watching Hazen Union Boys Varsity Baseball Playoff action on HCTV channel 1080. On your cable dial streaming worldwide and archived at www.hctv.us. Sponsors today, Buffalo Mountain, 472-5522. Buffalo Mountain supports Hazen, it's Buffalo Mountain Power Sports. And Sperry Lawn Care, 745-8336, when others can't cut it. Sperry's can. Leaf on camera, Lance here with the color and doing his stellar job on play-by-play, James Selvis.
Yes, thank you, Lance. As always, I'm here with the legendary Lance Hall.
And I get to go one-on-one with the great one.
His parents used to own Hall's Market down here in town.
Many years ago, yes, indeed.
Missed when it was Hall's Market.
A lot of fun in that store. A lot of fun.
Sure was.
There, almost 20 years we were there. And I tell you, they went by in the blink of an eye. And I got to tell you to mention one other place. The last game, we did a 10-inning marathon here against PA where we were raiding pizza joints around the
we sure were. I'm sure greater. Leaf enjoyed that.
Well, I'll tell you, when I got home, a little while later, a car goes by and toots, and it's Liz. She had been up to Smith's. She goes, she had her window, and she goes, got my pizza. Too funny.
Yes, Liz, the donut queen, as referred to by Lance.
Got a pizza that day up at Smith's Grocery.
Sure did. Well, Lance, you know, maybe if we keep plugging in these people's names, we'll pick up some more sponsors out of it.
Absolutely. We definitely want to thank Buffalo Mountain Power Sports and Sperry Lawn Care. They've been with us all season long
they
here
sure
for baseball.
Have. Very loyal sponsors. As you know, during basketball, we have a lot of very loyal sponsors
and,
as well.
And come the fall, we've got to hope that soccer will be back as normal as it has ever been. So HCTV will be looking for sponsors. And once again, we want to emphasize that they are archived on the World Wide Web. So if you want to go worldwide with your advertising dollar, do it right here, Hazen Union Sports on Hardwick Community Television.
There is a low ball by Lyle Rooney. Like I said, Smith Grocery, give us a call.
You can advertise your wares in from Taiwan to Tahiti.
To Bangkok to
Australia. Bali High. Anywhere you want to go, in between.
Yeah. Canada, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah.
Our neighbors to the north. 2-0 from Rooney, that's outside.
Austin to Boston, Maine to Spain.
It's going to be a 3-0 count now for Nate Bach. Barn? Box? I don't know how you said that, Lance.
I gave the sheet back. I believe it's Bacchus. I believe. Bacchus. I remember right, it's Bacchus. Draws a walk.
Kind of looks like an end, but He does draw a walk.
If I'm remembering right, I gave the lineup sheets back to John when I came
yes,
up.
Yes, Nate Bacchus.
I believe it's Bacchus.
All right. And now Cam Roy steps in for the Olympians. You see digital camo, gray and black uniforms with white numbers. That's one thing I don't like about these jerseys. They don't have any of that good Oxbow purple.
True.
That's hit hard on the ground. Rivard scoops it up. He's going to
nice
go to
flip.
Second for one. First, and that gets by. Out of play. Roy is going to get second, but they do get the out 6-4 on the flip to second. And then the throwing error, so that'll be an E4 on Tyson Davison.
And the batter will advance to second base.
On the passed ball.
Here in the top of the second with the Wildcats leading 2-0. So a lot of twos.
Yes, as Matt Cordy stands in. See him choke up real high on the bat.
Yeah, he's really up there.
Swing and a miss now for Rooney. Did you see a big crowd in attendance, as you would expect?
Always a good crowd here. I don't know. I think, you know, with the sun on it, I think that's purple camo.
Is it?
I can see number 12 here swinging in the on deck. That camo looks purple.
Purple and gray. Okay. Or yeah. Purple and white. Purple and gray?
I don't know. Maybe it's my glasses. It could be black and white. I don't know. I'd have to go down close and see.
It does, you know, now that you say it, Lance, it does look a little bit purple. It
might be my sunglasses tinting it a little bit.
Rooney gets the strikeout on Cordy. As you see, as usual during the playoffs, three umpires instead of the normal two.
Hit him.
That one got him. So Chris Roy get hit on the hand on that pitch by Rooney. Rooney in a bit of trouble now with two on and two out. 2-0 Wildcat lead. Rooney kicks and delivers. Swing and a miss. Montgomery snap throw down to second. Rivard, good job to knock it down. Keep it in front to prevent the throwing error, which would not have been what the Wildcats needed.
And I was watching this batter's stance. He kind of, at least on the first swing there, he had the bat way up over his head, way behind there.
Yep, still does.
Yeah.
That is hit high.
And foul.
Just next to the batting cage over there, the trooper tried to make the play. Opie ups him. Pitch now from Rooney. That's going to be low for a ball. 1-2. See the wind picking up now. Nice breeze.
Nice breeze, though. We need it. Blowing the clouds around.
High ball. He ducked it. Looked like a strike, but he's ducking pitches at the plate. 2-2 now.
Hey, if I was down there and I saw a ball coming anywhere near my head, I would probably duck as well.
There, strike three. Rooney gets
himself out of a jam.
He sure does.
So we'll move to the bottom of the second with the Wildcats.
Yes.
Leading 2-0.
2-0 for the Hazen Wildcats.
See what they can do in this inning. We saw a lot of aggressive running.
Sure
it,
did.
Worked.
They hit the ball pretty hard, too.
Yep. Yeah, they kind of, we saw a little bit of frustration from Lund.
Cody Hall in attendance.
Yeah, he'll be here for a little while, but his mother has forbidden him from staying here. He's got to go to soccer practice tonight. Still playing spring soccer. He's got, I think, two or three games left. So.
Yeah, you see, when your mom tells you to do something, you got to do it.
You got to do it.
She's the boss. Trust me, I know from experience. Dads are normally a little bit more lenient from my experience. One still on the mound for the Olympians, as to be expected, in only the bottom of the second.
Yeah. You know, first inning jitters, maybe, for
yep.
Lund. You can tell he gets definitely a little frustrated there at one point.
Sure did.
But
doesn't seem like he throws the ball overly hard, too.
His team played some decent defense behind him.
They did.
You know, we saw the pickoff at second. We saw the pickoff at third. So who's catching? Who's behind the plate for Oxbow, James?
Let me look here on the sheet. It is Nate Bacchus.
Great arm on Mr. Bacchus.
Yes.
So I'm using it to full advantage.
There is a pitch from Lund. It's going to be high for ball. Chase Lund, ball one. To Gould.
No pun intended.
Gould rips it. Ooh, shortstop takes a nasty hop. Gould's going to stay on his horse to first base and beat out a base knock.
Shortstop said, nah, I'm not going to take a risk here.
Speaking of Robbie Montgomery, driving in, I believe.
No, Robbie's sitting over
there. Oh,
he is. Robbie's been here from the beginning.
Oh, yes.
Yep,
so as to be expected.
Yep.
Kind of looked like him just out of the corner of my four eyes. Here. Fenton Meyer stands in now.
Meyer squares up the bunt.
I'll steal one of your nicknames here, Lance. Fabulous Fenton Meyer.
Fabulous Fenton Meyer, yeah. We had Fabulous Freddie Larson.
And the big red machine, Elliot Kimball, on that team as well. Shows bunt. Gets to the backstop and Gould. Not going to have to contend with a throw in there. Easy for the swipe bag. Hazen Wildcats continuing the base stealing action. As always, Gould, real easy base for him there at second.
Nobody out. What's the count? 2-0.
2-0 now to Fenton Meyer. One kicks and delivers. That's low for ball. Three and oh now, likely taken here, Lance.
I would think. Yep. For a strike.
Smart take. Even though it was a strike, smart take. A lot of times I said you're not going to swing 3-0, Lance, unless that pitch has to be really, really, really good.
Grooved, as they say.
Yes.
Swinging at that one goes foul. 3-2 now, full counts.
Yes, full count. To Fenton Meyer from Chase Lund. Meyer fouls it back to the backstop. Count remains full, 3-2. Gould at second. No outs for the Hazen Wildcats. Turk in the roost. Key word for a runner on second, Lance.
Turk in the roost.
Yes.
I've never heard that expression. Meyer takes strike three.
Backwards K for Fenton Meyer. There is another one that I heard Dennis Eckersley say. It looked like a pair of shoes up there. A pair of shoes at the plate.
Tyson Davison steps in.
I'm going to see if Lund comes with a yacker here, AKA curveball. Well, it was a ball. I don't know how much it curved.
Yeah.
Lance, have you ever heard of a pitch called a slurve?
I have not heard of a slurve.
It's a mix. It's
combination a combination slider curve?
Yes, it's a sliding curveball. Common in the majors. There's a high ball. 2-0 now to Tyson Davison. As you see, some of the Hardwick Little League in attendance by the looks. As they have a tournament named after Tristan Southworth, I believe.
Yes, played on Memorial Day weekend. Gold's going to go to third.
Yes.
Yeah, they usually play Memorial Day Saturday. I believe they played this. I don't know. Did it rain? No, it didn't rain on Saturday.
No, just a little bit chilly, though.
Yeah.
Got some golf in. It was kind of rough. As they play in the Tristan Southworth Classic.
Memorial Classic, yes.
Tristan Southworth Memorial Day Classic. As it's going to be 3-0 still to Tyson Davison. Lund in trouble again as Gould moves up to third. Moved up to third. That pitch is inside. Ball four to Tyson Davison.
Runners at the corner. Just one out. Bottom of the second.
Four. the man who is as dangerous as they come. Little shopper. Ethan Shoplin. This man has got to be batting damn near 600. Sorry.
So let's see what Ethan does. He swung the bat good last time. Got that high fly out there to the gap and right.
Excuse my language, folks. That one slipped out.
And then got picked off at second.
He did. Doesn't happen.
A very rare feat
to see Shoplin picked off.
Sort of a mental miscue there, which you don't see happen very often to Ethan.
No, not at all. Very composed.
See if he can bounce back.
That's strike one. Low strike call. Good frame by the catcher, though. Lance, it's all right. You know, it's live television. You're going to make mistakes on the mic once in a while.
Absolutely.
Happened to me against Fairfax a couple years ago. So.
There goes the runner. Davison down to second.
He dives in. Didn't have to. Just trying to get dirty. I'd love to see it.
Nice to get that dirty uniform. Now we got runners at second and third. For the shopper, 2-1 is your count.
With one down, as Fentmeyer was left a pair of shoes at the plate. Lund is going to kick and fire. That is roped out to center field.
Center fielder ranges under it, gets it.
Royan underneath it. Gould's going to tag up, and he is in standing, and the Wildcats take a 3-0 lead. Sack fly and an RBI for Little Shopper. That's one of the most fun terms to say, Lance. Sack fly and an RBI. For Little Shopper. For those of you who don't understand what that means, it means he flew out to the center fielder and drove in the run.
Now, smart base running before that hit, though, wouldn't you say, to have Tyson take second? Because then, James, if I'm correct, that takes away the force.
Takes away the force and the double play. So very smart to have him in motion.
You're learning, Lance.
Yes. See what watching a full season of baseball will do for you?
In another 5 years, I'll be right there with you, James.
Right.
T-Rex stands in. Tyler Rebar. So two outs now. Cats up 3-0.
First pitch from Lund.
Inside.
Inside for a ball. I think I've seen that same pitch called a strike. As you see, Oxbow's coach is going to tell his right fielder to push right a little bit, leaving a huge gap. If you hit that hard, kind of on a line, if you hit it hard on a line in between the center fielder and right fielder, that's at least two bags. With Rebar's speed, could even be three.
Yeah, Tyler, for as big a boy he's got, he's deceptive. He can, once he gets chugging, he can move.
He sure can. Oh-1 pitch from Lund. In there for a strike. I'm sorry. 1-2 now.
Rebar trying to keep this at bat alive.
Sure is trying to keep this inning alive.
Two outs now.
Rebar checked his swing. It didn't go.
Held up.
2-2 now. Two on. Or one on, two out, two balls, two strikes, second inning, 3-0. As Rivard is out at the plate.
I think Rivard wanted to say he was hit.
He was hit, Lance,
but he swung. Okay.
So even if you check your swing, swing and miss, if you even try and swing and you break the plane, or you swing at all and the ball hits you, you're still out.
You're still out, okay.
Yes, that's right. The only bad thing about being hit by the pitch, because you can swing and miss and it could bean you.
The trooper and Spencer out there, just to sort of go over things there. Opie Upson, the trooper. I bet you Leaf knows the trooper by Iron Maiden. That too?
He sure does.
The trooper.
Yeah.
Yes.
He definitely
I'm working up the courage. Give me another inning or two. I promised if Hazen hosted a playoff game that I would do a couple of lines from the Trooper. But I'm working up the nerve to do it. You know, I am no Bruce Dickinson, but
no idea who that is. I'm going to assume the lead singer of Iron Maiden.
James, your assignment is when you get done tonight, you go home and you YouTube Iron Maiden the Trooper. Preferably a live clip, just to see how great these guys are live.
Oh, I believe that they're great, and I've heard great things about them. I have just never listened to an Iron Maiden song.
Well, your assignment is then to go home tonight and listen to The Trooper by
Iron Maiden.
We'll
do, Lance. I'll text you about it, tell you how it goes.
On 11.
Yes, yeah, listen to it on 11.
Will do.
I was very pleased the first time I saw them. They still had the rhyme of the Ancient Mariner in their set, which is just an epic.
Also no clue what that is.
Epic. They based it on a poem by Samuel Coleridge. And Bruce Dickinson gives one of the greatest intros in all of rock to it, which I can't say on television.
There is a strike now from Rooney. Oh, one. Had to give my head a rest for a second.
Absolutely. A little bit of an ear break. There's a chopper up the third base line. Menard's going to come in, picks it up, and can't make the throw.
I think smart decision not to throw right
there. Yeah. Back. I mean, once it hit, the ball kind of deadened right down. Andrew had a ways to go. Lyle ran by. And
so
just nothing they could really do.
Base hit out of it. Just the button on the cap sometimes, Lance, and the headset on.
Yeah. Yeah. My ears need a break every once in a while.
Yep. I agree. You're probably used to it, though, from DJ.
Quite a bit. Yeah, I spent a lot of time with earphones.
That ball's hit hard. Rivard to second for one. On to first for two.
Double play.
Taylor made 4-6-3, or 6-4-3 double play.
Great fielding there by the Hazen Union Wildcats to turn that double play.
They do. They twist two.
After the run had gotten on first, so that little blip towards the third base. So
Lance, as the Taylor made 6-4-3 double play. Six being the shortstop who flipped to four, the second baseman who threw to three.
Okay, wait a minute. Did we have an overrule? I see an Oxbow Olympian on first base.
I do, too. He's out.
Yeah, I thought they had him.
He was definitely out.
A step.
I was going to say, if he was safe, I might have to go down there and argue myself.
Even from our vantage point, it looked like he was out.
I might have to argue from the HCTV, I guess not really a booth, but whatever you want to call it up here.
Our area of the parking lot.
Yes. This should say.
This is our space.
There's a strike one now to Carter Allen. This right here, I need to talk to John Sperry. This paint on the parking lot right here, it should say reserved for Hardwick Community Television. Channel 1080.
I think we've earned it this year. You know, again, this is our first year doing playoffs. Baseball.
I better say that on the roof up there.
Nice to have a playoff game. And I don't know. I think if we were up on the roof, we'd be too far back.
No, I'm saying it better set up on the roof for soccer.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's the most perfect spot of all time.
And swing and a miss by Allen. Rooney gets him to wave and miss. Head and shoulders. Take a whiff, as they say.
And that is the scoreboard hasn't changed, but that was the top of the third, correct? Yes.
Yes, top of the third.
So we move to the bottom of the third. The Cats up. 3-0.
Yes. Joy Hall now. Attendance.
Yes, she just got off work, so she's down here checking out the game.
Always good to see Hazen alums and current Hazen students.
That's the one thing.
Way
you know,
past
with,
Hazen students. Seeing
with Hazen, you get a lot of the alumni comes back, a lot of parents. Just some fantastic support for all three sports up here. And be it boys or girls, you get the support.
That's another big thing at People's Academy, too. You know, a lot of you always see alums, teachers, staff, coaches. At boys and girls sporting functions, especially soccer, Lance.
Soccer is huge.
That's where I see the most at PA. Basketball and soccer.
Basketball up here, definitely.
Yep.
And, the bigger the match, you pull in, say a PA or an Enosburg or somebody up here for a soccer game. I remember a soccer game against Enosburg a few years ago. Unfortunately, it was raining that day, so we weren't able to cover
here.
It. But, Lord, what a game that was. I was dying not to be calling that game.
I was here. That was a great game.
I actually got to sit over on the other side with John because I believe it was a playoff game, and I had done lineups, and John always lets me sit over there when I'm done. And what action it was that day.
I believe Hazen ended up falling that game, too.
I'm trying to remember if we did or not. And
because I remember coming to an Enosburg-Hazen game in the rain, and they lost.
What a game.
And I sat next to the big red machine, Elliot Kimball, who did not play soccer that year. As the butcher, the baker, the home run maker, Jaden Baker stands in. Mike Demand Baker over there watches on intently.
Absolutely.
I love Mike Demand Baker's hat. I have the same one. 2018 Red Sox World Series Champions hat.
First ball in for a strike.
Yes, good pitch by Lund. That's the one thing about baseball, though, Lance, is you pick up on the names awful quick. A lot quicker than you do in basketball.
Yeah.
And Baker rips a base knockout to center field. So the Wildcats got something going early.
Seen it happen each inning.
Sure have.
Bats have come alive for the Cats.
You betcha.
And you got to believe Baker's not going to, if they stay true to form, Baker's not going to stay on first very long.
No, he's going.
Great speed.
As Willie Mays Hayes said in Major League, where am I going? About 90 feet.
Lyle Rooney.
You see, they know. They just know. So they're going to make a snap throw back because they know. As Lyle the Rocket Rooney stands in. Call him the Rocket for his good arm on the mound. Pitch now to Rooney. That's low for ball.
Baker, big lead out there at first. Wanted to go bad.
Yes, he did. But he's going to decide to hold up on the ball. I believe it's 2-0, but it says 1-0 on the board. To Rooney.
There goes Baker. Goes. Throw down, Baker.
He's safe. Close play there at second base. Baker gets in on the slide. You knew it. He was going. As expected, he was going to be in motion.
Anytime there's a run on first, I'm always tempted to go with it. Part of the paradise by the dashboard lie, you know. Taking a big lead out there, almost daring to pick him off. Oh, he's in, no.
There's a high pop-up over to second base. And that is Reese Ilsley over there at second, puts it away. His brother, Bryce Ilsley, he played a whale of a game against the Linden Institute Vikings when I called that basketball game. James Montgomery steps
the runner
in.
Runner over. Baker's into third.
Baker still is safe at the three bag.
Yep, paradise by the dashboard light. Now there was a great baseball call. I'm trying to remember who they had with the call. It's a very famous announcer, and I should know.
Bob Uecker.
No, it wasn't Bob Uecker. Oh, so I'm going to have to look it up now. It'll drive me crazy.
You remember what team it was?
No.
Oh, fouled. Oh, jeez-um. That hit the top of the cage and came back here, Lance.
I'm going to have to look that up.
Hit the top of the backstop. Did you see
it? It kind of skipped off it.
Did. Montgomery has something against that backstop today.
Same thing last time.
As a catcher, I mean, he has something against that backstop.
He's kind of your friend.
Must have been looking at him funny. Baker with the wise decision to hold up at third base. Looked like he wanted to go, but he'll decide to stay. Beautiful day here at Dan Hudson Field. Full count now to James Montgomery.
Still just one out. Cats up 3-0. Runner at third. We got Jaden Baker on third. The always dangerous James Montgomery at the home plate.
James the Monster Montgomery. Chase Lund is still on the mound for the Oxbow Olympians. His pitch is decent. I won't say his pitch bad.
How about Jolton James Montgomery?
I agree. Montgomery.
He'd have jolted one on that one if he'd have connected.
Sure did.
The mauler.
He was swinging for positive pie there. You see, folks, I always try and bring in a couple local businesses here. Sometimes even throw in a sponsor as Andrew the Mauler Menard steps in. Like I said, Lance, Morse Insurance is one of our is Griff and I's favorite to say during basketball season because we always give Liz a hard time about it. Fouled back by Menard.
Over the cars.
Missed him by about a couple feet.
Missed it by that much.
Obviously, you can't see, but it's close, folks. I thought that might have been a sunroof smasher. That is low for ball. 2-2 now. Andrew the Mauler Menard.
Still just one out. Jaden Baker at third. The Mauler looking to slap one.
The only out is the swing and miss by James Montgomery. That's inside for a ball. Count reads full now to Andrew Menard. Menard ropes one into left field.
Over the infield.
Base hit, and he's going to have a ribby.
Baker comes in for zip. Cats.
Four zip, good guys. As Menard scores on the base knock.
Actually, that was Baker that scored.
Menard drove in the run.
Yes,
I'm sorry.
The RBI.
At least I didn't call him Isaiah.
That's right. If that was hockey, Menard would have had the assist.
Sure would have. But in this case, he has the RBI. Very big stat in baseball. Ooh, there's the old yacker. Curveball.
Spirited strike call.
You see it kind of go like this and drop a little bit. That's how you can tell it was the old curveball with the way it broke down. Gould swings and misses. 0-2.
Can feel the breeze back here from that swing.
Sure could. Bottom of the third. 4-0 Cats. That's outside. Good catcher behind the plate for the Oxbow Olympians.
He's doing really good. It was that Backus, you said, right?
Yes, Backus.
Yeah, got a great arm. He's made some great stops back there.
Lance, the Red Sox are playing a little later than usual tonight.
Yeah?
8:10 because they're in Houston.
Ah, okay. Central time.
Yes.
Little chopper. That's going to go foul.
Central, which I believe is 2 hours behind us.
I believe.
No, it might be three.
Central, I believe, is one. Mountain is two. California is three.
Yes, because California's on Pacific time, which
right.
is three. And Alaska's 4 hours behind us.
And Newfoundland is 1 hour ahead of us.
Yes.
Anything else you need to know about time zones, just ask us.
Yes.
I can tell you, Sweden is 6 hours ahead of us, because I do a lot of interviews with bands from like Sweden, and Finland, and all that, Germany.
And Scotland is
6 hours ahead
5 hours ahead of us. Gould rips one to center.
Nice catch by the center fielder to end the inning.
No problem out there by Cam Roy.
Put a couple on the board there, four zip.
Yep.
At the end of three, it is your Hazen Union Wildcats leading the Oxbow.
There you go, Lance. I was just about to remind you.
Action.
Just about to remind you about
yes.
our sponsors.
Our sponsors today, Buffalo Mountain Power Sports, 472-5522. Buffalo Mountain supports Hazen. And Sperry Lawn Care, 745-8336. When others can't cut it, they can. You're watching this HGTV channel 1080 on your local cable dial, streaming worldwide and archived at www.hgtv.us. Leaf on camera, Lance on color, doing the play-by-play, James Selvis. Now, Leaf, I've always wondered this with on the cable channel. I mean, this is obviously going to be archived. Do you show this on the cable channel as well? Are you able to repeat stuff on there, or is that all strictly live?
Oh, no. This goes.
So technically, you could watch this either on your computer or smartphone or wherever on the website.
Yeah,
or every once in a while, it's going to pop up on channel 1080.
Yep, it will be in the rotation. As soon as it goes up on the web, it will be on the cable channel.
Okay. Just like.
Yep. I'd always wondered that.
Everything you have to play.
Yeah. If I'm correct, Leaf, I believe during basketball and soccer season when we stream the games live, those are live on the TV as well as the website, correct?
Right.
Yes. And then they repeat on the TV. Okay. That's exactly what I figured. You see, Leaf Goldberg, executive director for Hardwick Community Television, he knows. If anybody knows, it's this man, Leaf Goldberg. Leaf Goldberg might be the best boss in the world, too.
He's awesome.
Sure is. There is a strike by Rooney. Rooney continues to deal on the mound, using that Rocket nickname very well.
Phil Rizzuto was the announcer.
Phil Rizzuto,
yes.
Great player,
yeah.
Actually.
Great
Hall
player,
of Famer.
Great announcer on Paradise by the Dashboard Light. And in between next innings, I'll tell you a little story about the first time I ever heard that song. It's pretty comical.
And what does that have to do with Phil Rizzuto?
Phil Rizzuto, in Paradise by the Dashboard Light, there's a famous baseball call in the middle of the song. There's a shot up the middle. Tyson can't get underneath it. Ball rolls in. Chopper comes up with it.
Tyson just missed it. Good range to his left.
It's just one of the great rock and roll songs. In the middle of it, there's a breakdown with an analogy. And Phil Rizzuto does a call on an imaginary baseball game. You've never heard Paradise by the Dashboard Light?
No.
James, that's your second assignment for tonight.
All right, Lance.
The group Meatloaf, Paradise by the Dashboard Light. And right in the middle of it, it's like this operatic song. It has like three or four different parts to it.
They take off for second. Throw by Montgomery.
Ooh.
Tagged by Rivard, loses the ball. He's safe. I think he would have been safe either way.
And in the middle of it, like I said, Phil Rizzuto does this incredible call on an imaginary runner getting to first, stealing second, and he ends up coming home. It's an analogy for the song. I'll let you know anybody.
You'll let the song do it.
Yeah, anybody who's heard it knows what it's all about.
You see the softball field over there getting some action today too.
Yeah. What do we got? Little League action going on.
Yes.
Over
swing and a miss.
But
by Nate Bacchus. One ball, one strike. To Nate Bacchus. That ball is hit hard on the ground. Menard scoops it up, takes a look. Second.
Goes to goal to first, gets the out.
He is out. One thing I have noticed, though, is this umpire is not very vocal behind home plate.
We've heard a couple of spirited strikes, but most of the time, yeah, he's been kind of quiet.
Yeah.
I think he picks his moments.
Pick your battles.
He knows timing is everything.
Sure does. Cam Roy steps in now for the Oxbow Olympians to face Lyle the Rocket Rooney. That ball is hit hard to right field. Meyer can't scoop it up. He's going to just go to the cutoff man, and Oxbow plates a run 4-1. That's
nice
just,
hit.
Yeah, you know, that is just precision hitting there, Lance.
Yeah.
You know, as a hitter, like I said, if you can try and aim it and flick one down that right field line, just like he did, you're going to get that knock every time.
Dropped it right in front of Meyer. He couldn't quite come in quick enough to grab it. Nice play, though, by Meyer to keep it in front of him.
Yes. That could have been extra bases. Bunt now fouled back to the backstop. Why is the runner still going?
He was running.
He was.
Yeah, he had his head down just running.
Matt Cordy stands in now for the Oxbow Olympians. 0-1 count now from Rooney.
Showed bunt on the first pitch.
Sure did. Fouled it right back to the backstop.
See what he does with this one. Swings away and a miss. Swing batter.
0-2 to Cordy from Rooney. Rooney is going to kick and deliver. Swing and a miss.
There's a runner.
Throw to second. Ball gets out again. But he gets the strikeout at least. I thought we were going to have the old strike him out, throw him out, double play.
Would have been a nice way to end the inning.
Sure would have. As Chris Roy, the designated hitter, stands in now. You see a DH for the Olympians. Pitch now from Rooney. Hit hard. Oh, what a mean hop at shortstop.
Yeah.
Throw by Baker.
Well. High. Runner's going to go to second. Slides in. Oxbow, little two-out rally here. They put two on the board now to cut the lead in half.
They have.
Like we
Rooney
say,
in a bit of trouble on the mound.
Playoff start, anything can happen.
Rooney normally much more composed on the mound, strikes
absolutely
out a lot of batters, but struggling against these Oxbow hitters.
Lyle is as pro as they come with pitching.
Jordan Johnson stands in now for the Oxbow Olympians. He's the kid with the high batting stance, like you said.
Right, holds a bat up over his head.
There's a strike.
Spirited strike call, yes, by the umpire on that one.
Lance, I don't know if you know who Kevin Youkilis is, but
yep.
Not quite a Youkilis stance, but that's a little poke shot off the end of the bat.
Davis has trouble with it.
Stays with it. Fires to first. He gets the out. Inning over. So the Olympians push across two as it's a 4-2 lead for the Cats. As I believe we head to the bottom of the fourth or top of the fifth.
Suddenly these Olympians, I think we're headed to the bottom of the fourth. Suddenly these Olympians have a little bit of life here.
They do. You know, that's the crazy thing about playoffs.
Playoffs. Yep.
All right.
Yeah, this is Fenton Meyer coming in, right?
Yes, Fenton Meyer. Double two. 22 in your program, number one in your heart, as the saying goes. You were talking about Don Larson, Lance?
Yeah, I can't remember if I've told the story once this year, forgive me. I'm sort of ringing a bell with me, but I'm not. I can't remember.
I don't remember it.
You don't remember me telling it to you?
I don't think it was when I was here.
In 1956, of course, Don Larson was pitching for the Yankees, pitched the only World Series perfect game an afternoon game down in Yankee Stadium.
1-1 to Meyer.
And my dad was a senior in high school that year, and his father, my grandfather, and some guys had tickets to the game. So Meyer gets one over to third, throw across.
And he's out.
He had gone to school that day, and he was at his locker that morning. Of course, this is back when World Series games were played in the daytime in the afternoon. He looks up, and here's his father, my grandfather, coming down the hallway in the school. He's thinking he's in trouble. You know, if your parents come to school, you're in trouble.
Most of the time, nine times out of ten.
My grandfather comes up and goes, you want to go to the ball game? My dad says, yeah. Apparently, one of the guys that was supposed to go had come up sick, couldn't make the game. He ended up going down, and it happened to be Don Larson's perfect game of the 1956 World Series.
Jameson.
Perfect hit, almost, right to the center fielder.
Can of corn.
Can of corn. So that's my little bit of baseball history. He was there, and he said that last inning, each pitch, you could hear a pin drop. And finally, when they got the last out, the thing he always remembers was Yogi Berra running out and jumping into Don Larson's arms. And
little shopper stands in. First pitch now to little shopper. Fights one, foul. Back here, nice barehanded catch by Rob Montgomery.
One of the fans.
Not Rob Montgomery.
No, not Rob, but somebody sent a little bit further. Nice catch.
Nice one-handed
the little
snap.
Shopper.
Never fails to disappoint. There's one hit hard on the ground. The third baseman getting his money's worth.
He's getting a workout over there third today. That three up, three down.
Yes, little shopper not happy.
That's what Lund kind of needed to boost his confidence back up.
He sure did,
quick
and get
innings.
The bats back for the
exactly.
Oxbow Olympians.
We saw Oxbow come alive.
They sure did as we head to the top of the fifth.
Now, the other story I can tell you, of course, is you know the Paradise by the Dashboard Light. I had been asked to leave a class when I was in school. I was eighth, ninth grade maybe.
So let me say, I'm going to guess what? That was 79?
78, 79. I can't remember exactly the infraction that I did, but the teacher sort of asked me to remove myself from the class and go sit in the office for a while. So I'm sitting in the office.
We've all been there, Lance.
This only happened on rare occasions because Shirley Colburn ruled the radio with an iron hand. And it generally was on
I definitely heard that name many, many times. Very big in the Hazen community.
It usually was like glued to WRK. Well, on this day, it was actually tuned to Shome FM out of Montreal. It was a classic rock station. Still a great station up in Montreal. And I'm sitting there, and this song comes on. It's real, you know, rockin' boogie-woogie kind of number. And then in the middle of it, this guy comes on and starts announcing a baseball game. And then this guy and this girl are going back and forth. You got to listen to the song. You know what I'm talking about. And I'm thinking, what is this song? It was the first time I'd ever heard it. And I was like, this is, you know, the craziest tune I've ever heard. Paradise by the Dashboard Light. First time I heard it sitting in the Hazen Union office.
With Shirley Colburn.
With Shirley Colburn, obviously wasn't there. Yeah. I want to say it was. If I had to guess, it was ninth grade science. I probably got asked to leave class. Teacher that year was a lady named Edna Napsick. Nice lady.
Rooney kicks and fires a high ball.
And I did. I don't know. We all have those moments of our youth.
Rooney is going to try and have a better inning than sitting on the hill.
Yeah, Lyle's looking to put three up and three down now and build his confidence back
up.
That's
sure
what
is.
He needs right now. You saw Lund, you know, if Lund gets, with the way these Olympians' bats went in the last inning and with the way Lund pitched there.
Yeah.
Yeah, Lyle needs to have a good solid inning right here. His defense has been playing pretty good behind him.
Yeah, they have.
It's just Oxwell's been hitting.
2-1 now to Reese Ilsley. Pitch now from Rooney. That's in there for a strike. Animated call. You'll love to see it behind the plate.
I like it when they kind of delay it. You know
Me
it's a
too.
Strike, but they kind of delay it and then come out with the real animated.
Man, that looked good, Lance.
Just a tad. If I was going to guess, maybe just a tad high.
I would have rung him
not
up.
Much.
I would have rung him up.
I'll tell you what, James, we'll find a chest protector and a mask, and you can go right down there.
All right. I'd be happy to.
I'm not going to.
Oh, we know,
Lance. I'll stand up here.
Andrew Emerson stands in now.
Baseball scares me.
runner on. It's not a very soft ball, I can tell you that.
No, a ball that hard, getting thrown that fast, I'm happy just to be up here.
Trust me, Lance, it doesn't feel good.
No.
I've been hit by it many times.
But it stings.
Sure does. Goes away after a little while. You get used to it after a while, Lance. That one's headed for the batting cage.
Yeah, like I get used to a root canal.
Don't know which one hurts more, honestly.
At least with a root canal, if you get the nitrous oxide, you're a little happy.
And the Novocaine, you don't feel it.
Sometimes.
Hopefully.
Runner goes. Throw down, Montgomery. Nice play by Tyson to scoop that one up.
Yes.
Runner in, though. Safe at second base.
Yes, Montgomery is yet to throw out a runner behind the plate. 2-1 to Emerson. See a lot of Oxbow fans here today.
Yeah, so like I say, it's a beautiful ride up from Bradford. Come right up 91 and over through Danville.
2-2. Yeah, that's somewhat in my neck of the woods when I'm at college, sort of. Bradford. Not far from Linden.
Can make it here in about an hour.
Yep.
There's one.
Misses the vehicle.
Yeah, I didn't hear a thunk.
I heard a thunk in the parking lot. That was about it. 2-2 now to Emerson. Rooney kicks and delivers. That looked real good. I am frustrated at that call.
Lyle.
Needed it. Full count.
Fire slow.
Ball four. Two on now to start the inning for Rooney.
No outs. Cats in just a little bit of a pickle.
Sure are. Carter Allen stands in now for the Oxbow Olympians. And a 4-2 lead in the top of the fifth for the Wildcats. Swing and a miss. Allen was swinging for Buffalo Mountain Co-op.
Lyle really needs to ring.
I believe Buffalo Mountain Co-op is one of our sponsors. There's back-to-back strikes. That's what Lyle needed.
One more and get that elusive first out here.
Oh, sure can. He needs it. That ball is flicked foul. Fought it off.
So different being out here in this like spring.
Right?
Technically, it's still spring. It's not the first day of summer yet.
I think this is the nicest day we've had to commentate the game so far, Lance.
As compared to being out here in the fall for soccer, I'm looking around at green leaves. You know, usually, we're looking at either bare trees or a lot of color, you know? This is nice.
Rooney frustrated on the call there. 1-2 to Allen. Rooney kicks and fires. Another strike. Yeah, you heard it. You heard it here first, Lance. Another strike. Could have been a little high, but I thought that pitch looked good. 2-2.
Shot. Andrew couldn't quite hire that one. That was it. Hard. Runner's going to come. Baker and Refire doesn't throw. Wants to go back to second.
And it's a 4-3 lead now for the Wildcats.
And no outs.
Menard takes his glove off over at third base. We hope he's okay.
That ball was hit hard.
That one got him right in the ankle. Although I'm sure he's...
I think Spencer wants to go over and check him out.
Yep. Although I'm sure he's used to being hit with a fast-moving object as a very other...
Yeah.
As another hard object to be hit with is a hockey puck.
Skate's usually a little higher, though. But.
Yep. But I'm sure a hockey puck can't feel good nonetheless.
No. And the Mauler, he's double tough.
He is. Hockey players are sure, they sure are tough, Lance. I think Andrew will be okay. Tough kid. If I'm Lyle, I would be frustrated with not getting some of those calls on the mound.
Yeah.
Because like I said, if you're a pitcher in this situation, Lance, the ump's normally going to favor you a little bit. But.
Olympians once down 4-0 have come back into this. It's 4-3 now. No outs. Top of the fifth.
Wildcats need to get the bats working.
Anybody's ball game.
Menard's going to stay in the game, and he is okay, thankfully. Menard is okay at third base.
Yeah, Andrew's not going to come out of this game.
No. Maybe see him on the mound here in a little bit. No offense to Lyle Rooney. Wild needs to settle back in. He pitched great the first few innings of the game. Looked lights out.
Well, that, like, you know, if we want to go with your eye up here, he's also got Chase robbed Lund. Of a few strikes. So
got robbed of a strikeout last at bat, which could have not resulted in a base hit. That's fouled off. And let me tell you, Lance, getting hit, I don't know what hurts more, getting hit with the pitch or getting hit with it off the bat. Mm. Off the bat probably hurts worse because it's coming faster off the bat.
Yeah, a little more velocity.
Well, sometimes, but that one was hit hard.
Yeah.
And swing, no, man, ooh, almost falls over.
He took himself out right there.
Thought that bat was going to go down to the Lamoille River. Chase Lund, the pitcher, in an 0-2 hole. Rooney kicks and fires. Check swing, foul. Lance, let me tell you, softball isn't that much fun either. I've dabbled in that at the college a little bit. So
yeah.
Charity softball games.
I played it one summer. It was okay.
Oh, diving stop by.
Throw to third.
He got him.
Nice play.
You see, Lance, that is when it's okay to go to third because he has to go to third, so you get the force. You don't have to try and make a tag.
Exactly. Short of throwing, you know, sitting down like that was really the only throw he could make.
Yeah.
And
only good throw he could have made.
Big out right there to and helping out his pitcher as well.
Stopping it from being bases loaded.
Yeah, getting a lead runner. So we got runners at first and second.
Rivard with the diving stop and then flipped it over to second. Dug out by Menard. As Nate Bacchus, who has the good arm behind the plate, stands
stellar.
In for the Olympians. Big, big turnout today at Hazen, as usual. High ball by Rooney. Spencer Howard on his way to the mound. Could be it for Rooney.
Yep,
that
Rooney
is going to be
the ball
it for Rooney.
Off. Let's see who they bring in.
They are going to go to Tyler Rivard. Rooney's going to go to shortstop. Lyle, all in all today, though, Lance pitched a pretty decent game.
Yeah, if he'd have gotten a few calls there, anything could have happened. But
I think, it would have.
That's baseball.
Yep, it would have helped his confidence a little bit more, I think. But all in all, except for getting roughed up the last couple innings, pitched pretty well.
So now with Tyler, we've seen good Tyler and we've seen bad Tyler this year.
Except for his, in relief, he has been good Tyler.
That's right. Yeah, we saw him start against Blue Mountain and struggle. In relief against
PA.
PA, he actually
pitched really,
well.
Really, really well.
So let's
I actually talked to Spencer
relief.
After that game when PA came back on Rivard that one inning. And I said, Spencer, I was like, I trust your judgment as always. And I said, I just think you left Tyler in a hair too long, in my professional opinion. And he said, He's like, it's a chance you got to take sometimes. And I said, Spencer, I totally agree.
Absolutely.
When he's pitching well, why take him out? If he's not tired?
Yeah, stick with him. And
yep. If he's tired, okay, then, And let me tell you, Rooney looks beat.
Yeah, Lyle definitely struggled some, missed some, got a few bad calls. It should have been strikes, but we've definitely seen him pitch better.
They were strikes.
But,
yeah, not Lyle's best game on the bump.
That's what happens.
That's baseball, especially as a pitcher, too. I think pitcher, in my opinion, is second hardest position on the field to play, besides catcher.
Catcher would be the first?
Yes. I've never pitched, so I don't know. I have caught that, but I've never pitched. And let me tell you, pitching, it's so – you can get your confidence thrown off so easily on the mound as a pitcher. Like one hit can just mess up your confidence and you could not throw good for the rest of the game after that. And some guys, you know, they don't let it get to them. It just depends on who you are and, you know, what
say,
game.
Definite combination of mental, physical, you know?
It is. You know, you got to be able to go deep into games sometimes. You got to throw a lot of pitches.
And shrug off a bad pitch or,
yes.
or a big hit or something.
Or
and
a bad call.
And do it
yeah.
Or a bad call. And
you know?
Very mental.
And especially, you know, because you get to hit at this level as a pitcher. So you got to make something happen at the plate, too.
So we got one out, top of the fifth. Cats clinging to that 4-3 lead.
As
Tyler
I said,
Revard in for relief.
He's going to inherit a ball.
That one low, runners advance, now to second, third. Take away the force and the double play.
Tying run at third, go ahead run at second. 2-0 now to Nate Bacchus. That's a fun name to say, Bacchus. Pitch now from Revard. Good block by Montgomery.
No relation probably to Jim Bacchus, who of course played Mr. Howell on Gilligan's Island.
I know that one, Lance.
Okay.
Didn't know Jim Bacchus, but I've seen Gilligan's Island.
My knee is broken.
Gilligan, obviously, the best character in the show. There's a strike. Low strike call. See, I saw Rudy throw pitches a lot nicer than that and call the ball. Just frustrates me sometimes as a commentator, Lance, let me tell you.
I'm going to trust your judgment on that, James.
3-1 now. And the bases are juiced. Ooh, baby, this is getting rough to watch. Tyson out there trying to give Tyler Revard a quick pep talk. Peppity talkity.
Cats definitely back on their heels right now.
As you see, the Cats are going to hug the grass, playing bunt defense.
I was going to say, yeah, they are definitely playing in.
Playing bunt defense to Cam Roy. The infield, the outfielders are coming in, too.
As well.
There's a strike by Revard. Good pitch. Revard is going to try and work out of this mess that he inherited via Lyle
Rudy. So what is the better strategy, then, to try and lay down the bunt anyway and squeeze a run in or tell the hitter to bat away and try and launch one over?
I would swing away because if you lay down a bunt,
yeah, everybody's right there.
A close bunt to the third baseman or the shortstop or anybody, you got to force at any base.
That's right. I'd be hammering.
Exactly. I agree. Especially if he grooves one in that outfield gap. Oh, boy. I don't even want to think of that.
Well, let me just say, if I was a manager, I would tell my hitter to hammer. I wouldn't hammer because I wouldn't be standing there.
Yes, but as a coach.
Yeah, as a coach, I would tell my hitter to.
Yes. See, it's called coach at this level, manager in college.
Okay.
Or the majors. I often wonder why it's called that, but maybe because in baseball you have to be a game manager. You know what I mean? You really have to manage a lot of things.
You
got to
manage everything.
Yes. But when you hear the term manager in the major leagues, for those of you that watch Major League Baseball, it's the head coach. Two and two now to Roy. And dropped third strike, but he got the strikeout. Tyler Revard now.
Trying to check his swing. Couldn't quite hold it up.
Gets a much-needed out number two.
Cats just looking to just get out of this inning and maintain this lead.
Get the bats up again.
Mm-hmm. We saw them go down. They went down 1-2-3 last time, correct?
Yeah, Chase Lund has settled in and thrown very well for these Oxbow Olympians, actually, after getting roughed up for four runs. There's a strike on a good pitch by Revard. I was going to say, Lance, if that one wasn't a strike, I'm unplugging my headset.
James is going down the hill.
Going down there. I'll get tossed. Not scared. Swing and a miss there.
I wonder if an announcer has ever been tossed from a game.
You know, Lance, not to my knowledge.
Could be, you could be the first, James.
I don't think they can hear me from up here, thankfully. Low ball. 1-2 now to Cordy. I know plenty, Lance, I tell you, if I was a coach, I would definitely get tossed. Let me tell you that. And a much-needed strikeout. Back-to-back K's.
Cats escaped right there. Tyler came in relief. And
back-to-back K's.
Yeah, we needed that one, definitely.
Sure did.
So we drop to the bottom of the fifth now. Cats clinging to a 4-3 lead.
We could use some run support here for Revard.
Get those bats to come alive. But like you said, Lund, after getting kind of knocked around there a little bit those first couple innings, has settled in, pitched well, and
we'll see if they stick with him.
See what happens.
Yep.
Get some.
So we head to bottom of the fifth, top of the sixth.
Bottom of the fifth.
Bottom of the fifth. Right, bottom of the fifth. We'll see who's going to stand in for the Wildcats. I believe it's Baker. Did you see a nice little written-up lineup card tonight from Spencer Howard?
Very nice. He takes care of us.
He sure does. You know, it's like I get in the point, you know, at least for the Wildcats and stuff, and in baseball, you know, you really have to look at it once and then you get everybody. You know, you get in a groove. Mm-hmm. And, you know, with basketball, I'm kind of the same way. You know, for the Wildcats, you know, I know everybody. And depending on who they're playing, I know most, like, you know, I know the Lamoille guys well, I know the Still guys well, and I know the PA guys well.
I always have trouble with basketball when if you get a coach that kind of sticks with starting five quite a bit, it's pretty easy. If you get a coach that, like, subs in and out every other, you know,
yeah,
play, then it can be a little more difficult.
You like Aaron Hill only puts in, you know, four guys off the bench, you know, so he likes to keep some of his starters' legs a little bit fresh.
You get these coaches with those big benches that like to rotate, you know, everybody in and out. That's when it gets a little bit of a struggle.
Yes. Lance, have you ever seen any other coaches here thrown out of a game in basketball? Has Aaron Hill ever been tossed?
To my knowledge, I myself
have never seen it.
The only one I have seen is Mike Demand Baker.
I saw Pete Everett, the JV girls basketball coach for People's Academy, get thrown out here last year on an absolutely bogus ejection. Hmm. Those refs were terrible. PA girls went on to win that game at the varsity side.
If I remember right, in that Enosburg-Hazen soccer game that I was at a few years ago, I believe their coach got tossed that game.
Who was their coach? Randy Lambsden?
No. I'm talking about the
Enosburg, the
soccer coach for Enosburg when we played them and over here.
He got thrown out.
I believe he got tossed that day. Yeah, went
he
out.
He got a red card.
Yeah, well, I mean, there was a call, and the referee drew a yellow card. Coach said something. Then he drew a red card. The coach went out and really tried to intimidate the referee, and the official was going to have none of it. Ended up tossing them. Yep. And ended up tossing some fans, too.
That was
a wild game.
As a fan, Lance, I can say I have almost been tossed a few times as a fan, especially when Hazen used to come to town in basketball.
Closest I came was at I think it was an AAU game over in St. J.
Strike to Rivard. Go ahead.
An AAU game over. Rivard gets that one to the shortstop. Rivard, can he beat that out?
Oh, I strongly disagree. That was a bang-bang play at first base. I think Rivard might have beat it, but.
Looked close. I couldn't tell.
Looked very close.
First
baseman
checking
up a
little
bit. And by the way, Lance, tie goes to the runner. That's a myth. If you've ever heard that term, it's a myth.
I have not heard that term.
It's a myth.
No real argument from the Hazen bench.
Nope. They're just going to see if their first baseman is okay. Might have got stepped on by Rivard.
Yeah.
And trust me, that hurts.
I was at a girls' AAU basketball game in St. Jay several years ago, and I was sitting beside Jimmy Belavance, and Jim got tossed that game, and I was sitting right beside him.
Is that Wyatt's dad?
Yeah, and I saw the referee point, you, out, and I thought he was pointing at me, and I'm like, it wasn't me, and Jimmy's like, you know, Jimmy gladly went out, sent a few parting shots to the official, and.
You know, Jimmy, that definitely doesn't surprise me, you know,
seeing
how Jimmy gets at basketball games, that definitely does not surprise me. Jimmy's a good guy, though.
Good guy. Always funny at the soccer games. Yeah,
sure
up on the
was.
Roof, I could tell where Jimmy was. You know, come on, kid. Come on. Good play.
Yeah. Son Wyatt, heck of a soccer player.
Yes.
Tank on the soccer field. Absolute truck. Good baseball player, too.
Mm-hmm.
And first
all the Belavance boys. Jimmy's brother Johnny was a stellar catcher here for Hazen Varsity back in the early 80s.
Yeah, first pitch to Baker is a strike.
One of the best catches. I'm sure Jimmy played too, yeah. All the Belavance boys played baseball.
Yeah.
Their older brother, Joe, was a very good baseball player. And
you see, Lance, you know Hazen history the way I know PA history.
Johnny was just an all-star behind the plate. He was just as good a catcher as I've ever seen.
As a base knock with one down, trying to get something going for the Wildcats.
That's right. We need be nice to see us put another run or two up here.
Yes, as Rooney stands in.
Lyle Rooney. Oh. Runner goes, throw
Baker
down.
Goes, slides in, he's safe at second base.
We've seen Baker do this before. We saw him got picked off over at third, though. So
Jaden Baker has swiped at least two bags today.
The Baker.
The stolen base maker.
Stolen base maker.
The hit maker. The stolen base maker. The home run maker. The man of many nicknames. Oh, one now to Rooney.
One out, bottom of the fifth. Rooney.
I believe it's still Lund on the mound. Sure is.
Number 10?
Yep.
Sticking
sure
with Chase.
Is.
Hey, why not? He's been pitching great.
He has been. Geez, Lance, I don't even know who to think of for a player of the game today for the Wildcats. They've all kind of played pretty decent.
They have.
Oh, poke shot.
Baker was running all the way. He's going to score. Baker got a great jump coming off second, right at the crack of the bat. He was gone.
He was. He was going before the bat, yeah. Anyways.
No questions asked.
He was going, and I knew he was going to score. RBI for Rooney. Much-needed insurance run.
Helping the cause right there.
Yes. Much-needed insurance run for the Hazen Wildcats, as it's now a 5-3 Wildcat lead. Oxbow's giving them all they could handle today.
Still just one out.
For Montgomery.
Jolton James Montgomery. Throw over.
As Lance Rooney gets back. That nickname from legendary Yankees player Jolton Joe DiMaggio.
There we go.
Hall of Famer. Very, very rightfully so.
Class act.
As a MLB record that will never, ever be broken. A record 72-game hitting streak.
Never. Montgomery lays down the bunt. Foul.
Foul ball.
And any guy who can play baseball that good and then go home to Marilyn Monroe, I'm a fan.
Right? I completely agree with you wholeheartedly, Lance. Marilyn Monroe.
She was Madonna long before there was Madonna.
I believe she was with Mickey Mantle as well.
I did not know that. But
she must have had a thing for Yankees, as I'm sure a lot of famous celebrity women did back then. Because the Yankees were probably the most popular athletes in the world at the time. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because baseball was the biggest sport in America back then.
That's right. Football was a distant second.
Yes. And basketball was long behind it.
Mm-hmm.
I would say basketball is kind of taking it now, but I don't know. Baseball's still darn popular here.
Football.
Football probably is taking
one.
It.
Number
yeah. one. I'd say it probably goes football, basketball, baseball. Oh and two now to Montgomery. That's low for ball. One kicks and fires outside. Did you see Bacchus behind the plate?
Thought about going
snap
up for first.
To first.
Could
Christian
possible.
Vasquez, the catcher for the Red Sox, does that a lot. Just flings one down to first.
Keep the runner honest.
Yes. Making sure nothing's going on. Oh, ball to the backstop.
Rooney goes.
Rooney's not going to have to contend with the throw as he's going to move up into scoring position.
Stand up, stolen base.
Swiped it easy. No problem. Montgomery, full count now. Montgomery, who I believe has drove in a run today.
Full count?
Full count. And Montgomery swings and misses.
Brings up the Mauler.
Andrew Menard swung for Hardwick United Church. United Church of Hardwick. And missed. If he had made contact with that, that might have had to Mackville.
That ball would still be rolling.
That you might have heard a splash at Mackville Pond. As yes, Andrew the Mauler Menard stands in. A good guy to have up in this situation. Wow.
That was a
he
swing.
He swings hard, let me tell you. I felt that one. Whew. Hard swing by Menard.
Going for the slap shot.
Sure was. And I'm sure that is a rocket off the stick of Andrew Menard. 1-1 now to Andrew Menard. But yeah, Lance, let me tell you, I actually almost got thrown out of a Linden girls softball game this
really?
Year.
Really?
Yeah. Actually, we all kind of did for chirping the center fielder for the Johnson Badgers. I didn't say anything too bad, but some of my counterparts did. Trust
gotta
me, Lance, it's all fun, you know?
Yeah, you got to have fun. Baller inside.
Yep. 3-1. I don't mean nothing by it. It's just fun having the game. You know, I've probably said a thing or two about some of the players on this Wildcat teams when they have came to PA from time to time.
No.
Derek Sauls in particular. That's low. Menard draws a walk. Probably smart for the Oxbow Olympians to try and walk him.
Brings up Asia Gold. And the Olympians coach going to go out and talk to Lund.
This might be it for him. And he's pitched very, very well. And I don't think, if I was the Olympians coach, I would definitely not be disappointed with the way Chase Lund is throwing the baseball today.
Hands
he's done.
Off, yeah. Yeah, excellent game. Like I said, you know, we both mentioned he got sort of knocked around there a little bit in the first couple of innings, but he settled in and pitched a great game since then.
He sure did.
So,
I'm not going to lie to you, Lance. From what I've seen this year, I know Rooney's their best pitcher normally for the Wildcats.
Yeah.
But from what I've seen this year, Menard has been the best pitcher I've seen. He's throwing the ball extremely well.
So while we get a little break in the action to change pitchers here in the bottom of the fifth with Cats up 5-3, two outs, I will take a moment to let you know that you are watching Hazen Boys Varsity Baseball playing the Oxbow Olympians. Playdown action, first playoff game hosted here at Hazen since 2007. Today is Tuesday, June 1st, 2021. Our sponsors today, Buffalo Mountain Power Sports, 472-5522. Buffalo Mountain supports Hazen. And Sperry Lawn Care, 745-8336. When others can't cut it, Sperry's can.
Now, oh, I lied, Lance. Lund has stayed on the mound. I lied.
I thought we saw him handling the ball.
I thought he did, too.
Yeah, maybe he took it back.
Maybe he did. Maybe he said, I'm staying in.
You can have this ball when you pry it out of my fingers. So Lund's staying in.
As he throws back-to-back strikes to Asia Gould. Maybe that mound visit fired him up again. Kind of shocked to see him stay on the mound, honestly, with two runners on. And swing and a miss.
Well,
now it's two strikes. My fault. I was looking at the wrong part of the scoreboard. 1-2. Kind of small, a little bit hard to see from time to time over there on the scoreboard.
Get the strikeout here, and everybody on the Oxbow side looks pretty brilliant for keeping him in.
Yep.
Asia fouls that one off.
You know, and maybe that was just a mound visit to try and, you know, calm him down a little bit on the mound.
Settle in.
Yep. As he has pitched very, very well. Game recognizes game, as they say, Lance.
Mm-hmm.
The two best commentators in the business recognizing, well, Oxbow's best pitcher. I don't know if he's the best in the business, but.
He's doing pretty good, pretty that darn might, good out here right
that
now.
That might be People's Academy's Ben Alex.
And struck him out.
As you heard the coach yell, adios, from the bench to Asia Gould. That is not something here every day. He yelled adios.
Something any batter wants to hear, really. So
no, it is not.
Cats
for our Spanish
do put a run on.
Yes.
Make it 5-3. We'll
get some
to the
insurance for Rivard.
Yes.
Who struck out two to end the inning.
As Leaf making an appearance today on the camera. Liz, unavailable today, Leaf?
She is.
She was busy.
She was busy.
Like we were talking before the game, it sort of snuck up on at least the folks out at HGTV.
Yeah.
Sure did. I mean, I knew about it on Sunday when I saw
James
the
James and I were
part.
Messaging back and forth yesterday about it, and I just never even, oh, my God, Leaf will know about this.
And
then
Leaf
today
didn't
I
know
I sort of get this panic message from Leaf today. Baseball.
Yeah.
James and I will be there, Leaf. We're there.
Don't worry. Yeah, Lance and I knew ahead of time, and we were good to go. Thankfully, I think I think Lance knew because of me, and then we were
I knew the pairings were probably going to come out Monday, and
they did.
I had looked at them, and I figured if it was going to be anybody, Thefford was going to draw the bye, which they did, and it was
it would be
Oxbow,
yep.
And
PA got the two, so they're guaranteed two home playoff games. As
two, count them two.
Top four seeds in any sport are guaranteed two home playoff games.
James, just on the odd chance, what's your alma mater, your school that you went, your school you went to high school?
People's Academy.
Okay, I'm just wondering. Heard a lot of PA today. I'm just kind of like.
Yeah, sorry about
it's
that,
like,
folks.
You know.
Just easy to mention.
I'm just giving you.
No, I know. Just easy to mention.
I'm just keeping you honest, James.
Oh yeah.
lot of PA chatter here.
I'm not ashamed to say it. Chris Roy stands in. He's the DH today. He hits one hard. Rooney's got to charge it. Scoops it up. Fires to Gould. Good pick.
Gould dropped it.
Ooh, thought he picked it at first.
Gould dropped it. Couldn't come up with it.
Gould, I thought, made nice. A heck of a pick. But
nice charge by Rooney to get it in there and get the throw over. But Gould couldn't quite find the handle on the ball over there.
So I don't think that's going to be a throwing error. That might be an E3.
Fielding.
Yes, that might be an E3 on Aisha Gould. See, Lance, you're starting to get the numbers down a little bit now.
Tiny bit. Tiny bit.
Because one is pitcher. Two is catcher. Three is first. Four is second. Five is third. Six is short. Seven is left. Eight is center. Nine is right. Little Shopper has got little to no action in the field today. I don't think he's gotten a single ball.
He's backed up a couple of the throws to second for Montgomery, but that's about all we've seen him do.
Yeah, he's not gotten any cans of corn out there in center field today.
No, I think he might have gotten one.
He had one, I think, yes. And Baker had one and left.
That's right.
But two guys who you normally see get a lot of action in Baker and Choplin have not gotten much action today.
Yeah. Definitely in that last home game against PA. Let me throw that in, James. Against PA.
Choplin
made some fantastic catches.
He sure did. He
against PA. For Hazen.
Yes. He played a great game.
Meyer settling in under this one.
He puts that away. Fenton Meyer, no problem out there in right field.
I think from now on, James, for the rest of the game, every time you mention PA, I'm going to try and match it with a Hazen.
Deal. We could go... We could go tit for tat.
We'll end up sounding like the Parrots down on the Hazen bench.
I sure will. The Seagulls from Nemo.
Yeah, that's right, the Seagulls. I keep calling them Parrots. Seagulls.
Yes, the Seagulls.
Seagulls from Finding Nemo. Yeah, the Seagulls. The Parrots are playoffs.
Playoffs.
Playoff the Parrot, and the Seagulls are the Hazen bench.
Yes.
Finding Nemo.
Great movie. 1-0 now from Rivard to Reese Ilsley. There's a strike. Loud pop of the mitt behind the plate by Montgomery, and he throws a rocket back to the mound.
Tyler settling in now, pitching good. Like I say, when Tyler comes in relief, it's pretty awesome.
He sure is. Rivard has thrown the ball very, very well.
Man.
Swing and a miss by Ilsley. Good pitch there by Rivard.
He's on it.
That one had some heat behind it. And as Dennis Eckersley would say, that one had some hair. And had some hair on it.
Runner on first, one out. Top of the six. Cats lead 5-3.
Pitch from Rivard.
Runner goes. Montgomery with the throw. Davison.
And he's out at second. Montgomery comes up big. Throws out the base stealer.
Big out right there for the Cats.
Makes finally, I think Montgomery was a little bit more prepared for that one than some of the other base steals. As you saw, some of Montgomery's throws in the other game kind of pulled him either to the right or to the left a little bit.
That one was picture perfect.
That was. Tyson threw his glove up, came right to him. 2-2 now to Ilsley. Rivard from the wind, kicks and fires. That's low, dug out, good block. Let me tell you, that's the hardest part about being a catcher right there, Lance, is trying to block a ball and knock it like right down in front of you. And it doesn't feel good either, even with the chest pad. And ball four. But that's why you wear the pads. Because trust me, Lance, I've been hitting the shin. I've been hitting that shin guard. I've been hitting the chest pad.
I'd have to be in a bubble before I'd even consider it.
Before you'd even consider it?
Yeah, before I'd even consider playing catcher. Put me in a bubble.
You know, Lance, I used to be kind of afraid of the ball, but once you throw the gear on and let some guys throw 85 at you for all practice, you know, you get used to it. And you know, Lance, I might have been dumb because in practice I used to have to catch for our pitchers on the mound when we would like throw in the gym. And I used to volunteer to catch. And I never wore a cup to practice, so.
Ouch.
Luckily, nothing ever happened. Because I was so good I could just block it off the chest and you know, wouldn't be worried. But
that is
also, the pitchers pitching to me in the gym threw it pretty good, so I just have to worry.
Runner
about
goes, Montgomery up, throw down, leads Tyson off a little bit too far. Ball goes in, Shopper backs him up. James a little off on that throw, and suddenly Tyler, last few pitches have been sort of
wild, a little erratic.
He was dead on for a couple of pitches. Now
he sure was.
See if he can settle himself in here. With a runner on second, two outs, Cats would dearly love to get this third out here.
They certainly
would. Send it to the seventh.
Oh!
Right back to Rivard. Rivard's going to make the easy flip over to Gould. And that will end the inning.
One more for the Wildcats.
Cats three outs away now from advancing here in the playoffs.
Playoffs. As they are going to have to wait and see the winner of the Northfield and
Bellows Falls.
And Bellows Falls.
Will we host Northfield, or will the Cats travel to Bellows Falls? And Bellows Falls is a haul from here.
It's a haul from People's Academy, too. Lance, let me let you in on something.
Hazen is a little bit closer, so.
Yes. Lance, let me tell you, we had a championship soccer game down there my sophomore year. And we were playing Stowe. Imagine that. Two teams, less than 15 minutes away from each other.
Mm-hmm.
You have to go to Bellows Falls to play a championship game.
Really?
Imagine. But it's just like that's the, you know,
at least
team that got
neither
drawn.
Neither team had the
game.
Advantage, you know?
Right?
So.
It was neutral.
Yeah.
That would be like if, you know, Hazen all those years, they were dominant. Played here instead of at the odd.
Right.
Although at the odd, it's basically like here. It's the same colors. If you think about it. You know, the odd has the red, white, and blue mats. The
yes.
Red, white, and blue lines on the floor.
Here, yeah. It's almost like coming to Hazen.
Just bigger. I love the Barry Auditorium, let me tell you. When you go to a game at the Barry Odd, whether your team is playing there or not, it is a different atmosphere at the Barry Auditorium. It is wild. I have had the pleasure of seeing Hazen win a few championships at the Barry Auditorium.
Been there for a couple, yeah.
I was there when they went back-to-back, 08, 09, 09, 10. I was a young bopper. Well, I'm still a young bopper, but as my gram would say. But I was a little toddler, probably 6-7 years old when that happened. I remember that well, actually.
I can remember going to the Barry Auditorium in the 70s to watch Grand Prix Wrestling. I saw Andre the Giant back when he was Giant Jean Foray down there.
Wow. Hulk Hogan?
No, this is long before Hulk Hogan. Hulk Hogan was just a gleam in his dad's eyes back then.
All right, Lance, who's better, Hulk Hogan or Andre the Giant?
Well, Andre the Giant, of course. But,
all right. Well,
but I also saw the Duke brothers down there, the Vachon brothers, the Italian Connection, Gino Brito and Dino Bravo. I got Killer Kowalski's autograph down there.
Ric Flair? He was probably around then. Maybe not.
No, that was before Ric Flair was just breaking in back then. These are a real old time.
Yeah.
Back then, if you want to go WWF, you're probably looking at like Bruno Sammartino, Ivan Putski, Chief J Strongbow back then.
There's Robbie Montgomery making the barehanded play over there.
There we go. But, that's when I first went down to the Barry Odd. It was back in the
I didn't even know they had impromptu wrestling back then.
This was back in the 70s, yeah. There's a high pop-up foul as well.
Hazen Bench going to – what? I don't know what Rivard was trying to do over there.
I don't know either. But it was a lot of fun. A lot of fun back then.
I'm sure that was. I would love to see WWE come back to Vermont, but there's not really any venue to host that many people.
I saw him once at the Burlington Auditorium. Who was there that night? Lex Luger, The Undertaker, Yokozuna was there.
They came here?
It was the Burlington Auditorium. That would
the
have
Undertaker.
Been, Undertaker was there that night. That would have been 1993.
So Undertaker was very young in his career.
And I'll tell you, his entrance, when you're there for it, was spooky. It was spooky.
It's always been spooky.
You know, all in the dirt.
Sorry, I've kind of gone off on a tangent. 1-2 to Meyer. but Lance, it's always spooky. Even watching matches and stuff just online, it's always, you know, gives you the chills.
Exactly. Lights go down and that bell tolls and that music, that organ music
starts. The lightning.
Yeah.
When his eyes roll in the back of his head.
Yeah. Lund stays in, gets a strike there, strikes him out.
Meyer, pair of shoes. Tyson Davison stands in now. 8-9-1 due up for the Wildcats as we saw number 8 go down.
See if the Cats can maybe tack on any type of additional scoring here. Chance to pad that lead before we go to the 7th.
Yes.
Now, playoff games are still 7 innings,
yes,
correct, James?
Yes, 7 innings.
Davison.
I guess got hit.
Hit.
The ump said he was moving all of his pitches in, and that one just barely got him. As now, as dangerous as they come. High stirrup, little shopper, Ethan Shopland.
And this is where you usually see Ethan kind of come up with something. You know, he's been a little, hasn't had a whole lot of action out there in the field.
Hasn't swung the bat very well today. And I spoke too soon.
Did we call it or did we call it?
The announcer's jinx wasn't with us that time, Lance, let me tell you.
The shopper usually comes up with something there.
He sure does. You know, little shopper, extremely clutch. You know, whenever you need something, whether it was a big shot in basketball, big goal in big stop in soccer, in net, big hit in baseball, you name it, shopper's got you.
A rebound, a catch, whatever it takes, you know.
Big shot. He's like a Robert Horry, big shot Bob.
Rivard, T-Rex.
Another excellent athlete in his own right. Rivard, I believe, plays soccer and basketball. I don't know if he plays soccer, but he plays basketball.
Yes, he played soccer.
See, you'd know.
And basketball.
I know he plays
force.
Basketball.
He was a force inside.
Really, Hazen's only big man, him and Lincoln Mitchett. Two twin towers in the paint for the Hazen Wildcats. I remember having the pleasure to call them both as freshmen. Rivard hits it on the ground. They're going to go to second
force
to get one. Rivard's safe.
So we'll have runners at the corner, two outs.
Downs. And Jaden, the butcher, the baker, the home run maker stands
in.
The hit maker, the stolen base maker, the home run maker, whichever one you would like to use.
This guy's had more hits than Elvis.
Insert metaphor here for Jaden Baker. This man also, like Little Shopper, wears a lot of hats. And is a very clutch player in his own right.
Looking to send Hazen to the top of the charts with a hit right here.
Sure is. That's low in the dirt. Good. Good stop. As you see, Lund is still on the mound for the Olympians. One more run here for the Wildcats would be huge. Give them a 3-0 cushion for Rivard in the bottom half. There it is. You see, they've kind of, I don't know how, if it's been intentional or not, but they have kind of pitched around Baker today.
Mm-hmm. They know
that Baker and Shopland.
Standing in the on deck.
And Rivard, you know, basically a lot of guys in this Wildcat lineup, you give them something to hit, they will hit it. Couldn't ask for a better night for baseball, though. Absolutely gorgeous night. Finally got away from that cold and rain. And
just enough of a breeze to keep the bugs down.
Right. Which this weekend, though, we're getting those.
Yeah, black flies will carry us away.
Black flies are going to take over. It's like Birds by Alfred Hitchcock. I don't know if you've ever seen that movie, Lance.
I have.
Birds.
The Birds.
Kind of a creepy movie, honestly.
Rivard takes off.
Fouled off by Baker. 3-2.
Go back.
Full count to
two
Jaden.
Outs. Bottom of the sixth. Cats lead by two. Runners on the course.
Jaden Baker trying to get some added insurance. Get some AARP. Or get some Morse insurance. I'll say that one. There's our sponsor. One of our sponsors for basketball. For the Hazen Wildcats. Pitch now to Baker. He rips one back here.
Into the trees.
Almost got into the apple tree. Bounced right before it. Lance, like you said, I don't know if there's any apples on those trees.
I don't either.
Probably at one time.
In a land far away.
3-2 pitch from Lund. Oh, my God. Rocket.
And the Cats get that insurance run, and
6-3
Baker
now.
Gets on.
Wildcats needed that. 6-3. Knocked in insurance run by Jaden Baker.
Upsets Lyle Rooney, as that ball was just
smacked.
Bazooka'd.
That was tattooed.
Shortstop. He made the stop, but couldn't come up with it.
That must have hurt, too. That one hit him right in the shoulder.
Lyle on base last time. I believe he drove in a run last time.
He sure did.
Two outs, top of the six. Cats up 6-3 now.
The Rocket, Lyle Rooney. Oof.
Rivard on second, Baker on first, and the pitches are starting to come inside a little more and a little more.
They are. Rooney, who we know is a good all-around ball player.
Fantastic baseball player. Rooney up to third.
Oh, and a missed
field. Wow.
A fielding miscue by the Oxbow Olympians.
Really,
man.
All he had to do was step on the base, correct?
Yes. All he had to do was tag him.
Mental error. Who's playing third over there? It's number 11, is it?
Yes, Jordan Johnson.
Got to feel sorry for him, you know? And he sort of stepped that way, and I don't know.
You do.
You got to be in it, but you know what? Things happen.
Chase London, I think this is it for him this time.
See the Olympians coach, Pat. Who's number 11 again for the third baseman?
Jordan Johnson.
You see the coach, you know, Pat Johnson on the shoulder say, hey, you know.
Yes.
It happens.
Lund's day is done. And, you know, for the most part, he pitched a pretty darn good game for the Wildcats today. He shut them down for probably three of the.
Yep.
As now number four, Carter Allen is going to come on and toss.
Now, James, would that count as a hit or an error on the third baseman? Or
error.
How is that? It's an error.
Error. Base hit and an error, I believe.
You got to feel bad for the kid.
It would be called a base hit E5. Base hit E5.
He was literally two steps away going that way and then turned and just lost track of who was on base where and what was happening. And
he sure did.
And I'll tell you, as somebody who came into calling baseball as a total novice, there's so much, like we've said it a couple times, baseball goes from nothing happening to quantum physics in the crack of a bat.
Yes, it's not like basketball or soccer, which is fast-paced action, and there's a lot going on most of the time.
Right. So
baseball can be very slow at times.
Really feel bad for the kid over there. It's too bad.
I do, too. You know, Lance, I feel bad for him, too, because, you know, we've all been there.
Yeah.
I played right field, so, you know, I didn't have that same pressure as playing the hot corner. Mm. I played outfield and second base. At the varsity level, pretty much just right field. Yeah. JV, I played second base and played third once. But, in right field, I think, you know, at any position when you make an error in the field, you know, you just feel so bad. Mm. And, you know, that's why your teammates are there to, you know, pick you up.
Just got to shake it off.
You do. Yeah. But that is less of a fielding error and more of a mental error.
Right,
well,
definitely.
Actually, I don't think that would be an error. That's actually a base hit. I'm sorry, because he didn't throw it or, you know.
Yeah, he held on to the ball.
He held on to it, and so that's just a base hit, but that's a mental error.
So we do have a pitching change now. Who came in to pitch?
Carter Allen.
Carter Allen comes in to pitch. Bottom of the sixth, two outs. We've got full bases. The bases are drunk.
Bases are drunk, yes. You took that one from
They're
me.
They're loaded.
As Dennis Eckersley would say,
that's right.
One of my favorite terms, the bases are drunk.
James Montgomery up to bat here.
Montgomery looking to have a big at-bat for the Wildcats.
James Montgomery.
Yes, Jolton James Montgomery looking to break things open, Lance. I thought that was a little low. Seems like he likes the low ones, the home plate umpire.
He has been calling low ones consistently. We'll give him that.
He sure has. As you see, Lance with the freshest kicks in town, the New Balances. Got my lawn mowing shoes on.
Ah, okay.
My beaters.
I let Cody mow the lawn.
It's pretty easy when you got a riding lawnmower. I like it.
He's got a self-propelled.
Those ones are nice, too.
Yeah.
0-2 to Montgomery. That is going to be high and outside. You know, it's not too often, Lance, you see a batter stand in with no batting gloves, as I definitely couldn't. Mm. You know, they wear batting gloves to help, you know, take out some of the sting,
yeah.
Some of the vibration.
Especially with those aluminum bats.
Yeah, and wood especially. Wood stings.
Montgomery strikes out to end the inning, and a decent bat flip there.
I'll give him a 6.5.
Yeah, really good bat flip there. He got, you know, a couple of good spins on it. Held on to, there's that semi-helmet. Oh, he made it into the dugout.
All right, so. I'll give him a 9
yeah,
for
decent,
making it into the
decent helmet toss to get it
into
the dugout.
Batting gloves are going now, Montgomery. I mean, Yep. It's a throwing parade over there. Put him on the hill.
So we move to the top of the seventh. Cats three outs away from advancing.
They sure are. For the first time since 2007. Well, actually, that's not true. They beat Williamstown a couple years ago.
In Williamstown.
Yes.
Hazen Boys Varsity Baseball. This is playoff action against Oxbow. Tuesday, June 1st. Our sponsors today, Buffalo Mountain Power Sports, 472-5522. Buffalo Mountain supports Hazen. And Sperry Lawn Care, 745-8336. When others can't cut it, Sperry's can. You're tuned to HGTV, channel 1080 on your cable dial, streaming worldwide and archived at www.hgtv.us. Leaf on camera, Lance here on color, going one-on-one with the great one. Little homage to The Rock. Talking to James Salvis here.
Can you smell what The Rock's cooking?
I think we can smell Hazen. Can you smell what the playoff action
can you smell what the Mahler's cooking?
Mm-hmm.
So, cue The Rock's theme song. The Trooper, Opie Upson down there.
Oh, yes. You take my life, but I'll take yours too. You fire your musket, but I'll run you through. Opening lines of The Trooper by Iron Maiden.
Yes, Lance. Never heard that song, Lance, but you
your assignment tonight is to go home and
both of them actually
listen to the Trooper by Iron Maiden and Paradise by the Dashboard Light. You're probably going to like Paradise by the Dashboard Light a little better because it's got the baseball thing to it, but the Trooper is just one of those great fire 'em up.
Speaking of the Trooper, there he is, Opie Upson.
Of course, a member of the Vermont State Police Force. This is why we have nicknamed him the
yes.
Trooper.
Very fitting nickname. There you see Joe Rivard making a strut back over to the bench, join Spencer Howard and Opie Upson. See Opie Upson, the only assistant coach that wears a uniform. Most coaches do at this level. Okay. As the Mahler in to try and close things down now. Oh, never mind,
Tyler.
It's Rivard.
Tyler's still on.
Menard was on the mound earlier when they first went out there. Maybe he was just moving to third, but I looked and I was like, that is way too tall to be Andrew.
Sticking with Tyler to close this one out.
Shut it down.
Strike one. James going to go out to the mound and speak
to a little
to
dispute Tyler. With the umpire there. You know, Lance, I was told why the umpire goes like this and turns around when he brushes off the plate, but I was never... I can't remember why.
Okay.
But I was told why. I just can't remember.
Just can't remember.
I think it's because he doesn't want to brush dirt on, like, the batter or the catcher.
Maybe.
If, you know, because if he brushed it off the other way, it would all go on the catcher.
Yeah.
So if he brushes it backwards, it doesn't go on anybody.
Two strikes for Rivard.
So. Yes, 0-2.
Great start.
To Carter Allen. And wave and a miss. Rivard reared back and just fired that one in there. Hard fastball right over the heart of the plate. Wave and a miss.
The other,
two to
other,
go.
The other line I always liked from the Trooper is the smell of acrid smoke and horse's breath. Just a great image there. You know, I mean, that's like metal.
You see Leaf
that's
shaking,
metal.
Yeah, Leaf shaking his head. And
that's a metal line right there.
You know, you and Leaf seem like metal music fans,
we
not
are.
My type.
Leaf and I have had fantastic conversations.
I can get behind rock and roll, but not metal. Metal's like one of the only music genres I don't like.
We're going to have to convert you, James.
I'm sure it'll come with time.
High.
Ooh, high. Yeah, that one was definitely a ball.
One and one.
I will not argue that one.
Don't dispute that one.
Nope.
One and one. One out. Cats up three. Top of the seventh.
Chase Lund
looking to close things out.
Chase Lund at the plate. Beautiful night for baseball.
High pop up, and that'll be strike two. Is that one's behind the dugouts? Nobody gonna get to that one.
Nope. One and two now. To Chase Lund.
So once again, winner of this game will play the winner of the Bellows Falls Northfield game, which Bellows Falls
is heavily favored.
Heavily favored.
Although,
but,
Hazen,
know.
Who was 0-15 a few years ago,
yep.
No wins, went in and beat one of the top seeds in Williamstown.
Mahler down, throw across.
And he got him.
Two outs.
One away now for the Wildcats to advance in the playoffs for the second time in 5 years. Which is a pretty good feat if you ask me.
absolutely.
You know, that's, you know, one of the craziest, I remember hearing about that, you know, one of the craziest upsets, Hazen being 0-15, going to Williamstown, who I believe was a top four seed that year, and they beat them.
Anything can happen. Come on, Nate. Come on, Nate. Here we go. Ball one. Come on,
Nate. As Nate Bacchus stands in for the Oxbow Olympians. 0-1.
Rebard
kicks and fires.
Bacchus has been fantastic behind the plate for the Olympians today.
He sure has. And the Wildcats now. Undermined. It's 1-1. Two outs. Wildcats. One out away. Kicks and fires. You see Rivard firing the gas. He wants it. Rivard can smell round two.
Give him the heater, Ricky. Line for Major League.
Yes.
Ooh, there's a
hard on the ground. Rooney scoops it to first. It's late and he's safe. So Oxbow gets one more chance. Gets another chance here. Hazen fails to put him away. As Cam Roy stands in now with a runner at first. And two down. Rivard going to try and get him. And send these Hazen fans home happy. And send the Olympians packing. Rivard kicks and fires.
Hi.
Lance, I got a hunch who my player of the game is going to go to today. I'm thinking either Rivard or Rooney. Rooney with the bat. Rivard with the defense. Rivard stole a couple bases today. I think he drove in a run. Made some great defensive plays.
Played well.
Sure did.
Cats now one strike away.
One strike away. Ken Rivard, finish him off. Two strikes to Cam Roy. One ball. Seventh inning, 6-3. Rivard sets, kicks, delivers. That's blocked by Montgomery.
Nice block.
Two and two. This will be the first time the Wildcats have won at home since 2007.
2007, yes. A playoff game, yes.
Yes. So hit hard.
Davison, easy scoop.
To first base.
And
the Hazen Wildcats are headed to round two, folks. Rivard with a gem on the mound. I'm James Salvis on the call. My player of the game today, with Lance Hall on the call, Leaf on camera. My player of the game today is going to be Tyler Rivard, with the honorable mention going to Lyle Rooney.
Tyler made some great plays in the field and at the plate and some hitting as well. So, yes, I agree with you on that. Once again, this has been Hazen Boys Varsity Playoff Baseball as they have beaten the Oxbow Olympians. They wait now to see who's won against Bellows Falls and Northfield. Our sponsors today, Buffalo Mountain, 472-5522. Buffalo Mountain supports Hazen. And Sperry Lawn Care, 745-8336. When others can't cut it, they can. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.